Broadcasting live from the campus of UMass Boston, this is Beacons Women's Hockey on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Hockey is back at the Beacons Ice Arena. So glad you're with us. My name is Tyler Murray, and we're excited for a new season of hockey here in Boston, Mass. And this year, we're very excited to be joined by our new analyst, Matt Meisenbacher, a former Beacon standout goaltender. Matt, it's great to have you here.
Yeah, thanks, Tyler. Definitely good to be here, and did a lot of watching from the bench back in my day, so the only thing that's going on now is a little bit higher above the ice.
Meisy is like the mayor of UMass Boston around here. Everyone excited to see his debut and listen in on the Beacons Broadcast Network. So again, great to have you here. And a big night, not just for the Beacons opening their 2014-2015 season, but for William Smith College, the Herons, making their NCAA debut. Congratulations to William Smith and their first-year coach, Jamie Totten. It's a roster full of freshmen. It's going to be maybe a tough road ahead, but we're certainly proud of this program. Very excited to see what they can bring to the ECAC West. Let's check out the team leaders for the Beacons from a year ago. This squad won 12 games and got knocked out in the semifinals of the conference championship 2-1 in overtime to Norwich just last season, and Norwich went on to the national championship round. And Meisy, you can just see how well Samantha Fallon played last year to lead this team offensively.
Yeah, Tyler, she was tremendous. I mean, really the offensive power ran through her, finished the season with 19 points. And she was supported by Emily Howard and Alyssa Sullivan. I think you're going to want to see more of the same this year. She's not going to be able to do it by herself, and I think those two are going to be your highlight supporting cast.
If you're a William Smith fan, if you're a Beacon fan, a lot to be excited about opening night here on the campus of UMass Boston. And let's check out now what the players and coaching staff had to say to our own Seth Orensky before today's game leading up to this season and our 2014-15 season preview.
It definitely still hurts the ending of our last season, but it just showed that we can do it. And in beating those top teams, it gave us a lot of confidence, and I think that helped us in the end come as close as we did.
Now we clearly know we can do it. It gave us a lot of confidence going into this year and a huge chip on our shoulders knowing that we're coming for other teams. And I think other teams should be a little nervous for what we have coming this year.
It would mean a lot to us because we've all been working hard together the past 4 years. The ones remaining stuck it out. We're still here. We know we have to work hard, and that's our main goal. It's our last year. We really want to win that championship.
After Norwich, I think it's going to be great to start out at home. We're playing a new team. We can't take them for granted, that's for sure, but it's definitely going to help us and give us more confidence with our crowd and get the excitement going for our home game. They've been great so far. Ron in the gym, we've never been this strong before in my 3 years here. We're lifting a ton of weight. We're stronger than ever. Taylor, our new assistant coach, she's awesome. She ran a few practices. She's doing great, giving us some awesome new drills.
We need to buy in right away. Last year it took too long to buy into coaches' systems and know that they actually work. But this year I believe with all the returners we can jump on that right away and really get after it.
I think Mo is going to be unreal this year, just as she was last year. She's been big for us in net previously, so I think she's going to be great. Burke and Casey, they're going to be right there with her. They all look good in preseason, so we're excited to see them in net. I think this year's defense is going to be just as great as last year. We're all returners, actually. We're not getting anyone new, so we're strong. We know our defensive zone pretty well, so I think it's going to be great.
Well, we lost a few forwards that definitely had major roles on the team. The younger kids are definitely stepping up. We have 7 new people. They're all going to play a big role. We're all mixing together well.
We've got some returners that are standing out extremely. Jess Salisbury is standing out. She's stepped up a lot this year. As far as new people, Sarah Alinardo, she's stepped up. She is doing really well right now. Lizzie Aveson, Jane, they're all quick players, good hands, smart players.
Playing those kinds of teams gives us confidence. Like, we tied the team from Minnesota. We knew they were a good team. It boosted our confidence. It lets us know that we can and we will beat anyone to get to the championship.
We're definitely looking forward to Codfish, but I think we're also looking forward to getting some revenge on Norwich and those other big teams such as Holy Cross and St. A's that we're always head-to-head with, so playing them is definitely going to be one of our biggest priorities. Definitely want to win a championship and just come together as a team.
Win a championship.
we just want to win a championship. We came so far last year, and that really hurt. So I think everyone's going to carry that with them this season, and hopefully we come out on top.
Starting lineups being introduced right about now, folks, which means we're seconds away from the national anthem and minutes away from puck drop. Let's quickly check in with our pregame interview guest, head coach Colleen Harris.
All right, folks, we're here with women's hockey coach Colleen Harris. Coach, thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
So let's talk about last season a little bit, leading into this season. A very impressive campaign last year. What are you looking to build on from last season, and how high do you think this team's goals are and the expectations for the Beacons this season?
I think last year gave us a lot of confidence. I think it gave us a huge boost, just turning things around after Thanksgiving last year, and then also carrying that all the way through a Codfish Bowl championship and on into taking down Manhattanville for quarterfinals and actually playing a heck of a game against Norwich, and you know, just losing short in overtime to them. So I think that just gave the kids a different kind of mindset and a different kind of belief that we can actually do something pretty big here.
You've got 11 seniors this year. That's the most in UMass Boston women's hockey history. A lot of returning players as well, especially on the blue line. How much confidence does it give you as a coach and as a team knowing that a lot of these players have already had success with your program already?
It's huge. I mean, it's awesome. The first couple of weeks of practice have even been different, how we attack things and what we're introducing a little bit earlier, because they now know our systems and they have bought into our systems, and now we can kind of get creative and do some different stuff here.
We saw what this team is capable of with Moe Bradley in between the pipes last season. How much comfort does it give you to have her back in goal this season going forward?
Oh, it's great. I mean, both of our goalies are seniors, and so having a nice 1-2 punch there is huge for us. I think either one in net, the kids have confidence. So, you know, they're playing for them, and it's nice to have two that we can constantly count on.
Now, your captain, Alexandra Carlos, has talked about the importance of buying into the system early this year. Maybe a slow start to last season, but obviously it picked things up very nicely. What does that mean, you think, buying into the system? What is your system for the Beacons this season?
I think the entire thing is, you know, everybody has an important role on the team, and understanding and accepting your role is kind of the most important thing here for us all to be successful as a group of 28 kids and a staff. So they work their butts off day in and day out, and they're fighting for their spot, but they also understand that if it's not their spot, if it's not their time to go, whoever else is going, they have to have their back, just because that's the most important thing is going in as a whole unit rather than just single players.
And finally, Coach, you talked about how close this team was to a conference championship appearance last year. And throughout the entire season, are there any points of emphasis you have, any keys to victory and success for this team going forward that you might want to see improved off of last year? Or is it really just that close, one goal separating you from the next level of success?
I think one goal plus 100 other goals. so I think scoring offensive opportunities and creating more opportunity in the offensive zone is really going to help us. Our D, we do bring back a really strong D core, so we're counting on them. We're expecting them to hold it down back there, but then we really want to find a way to bury pucks and take control of games rather than kind of be on the edge of our seat.
That's Coach Colleen Harris, folks, and thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Looking forward to a great season, and the game's coming up soon.
Back here live on the campus of UMass Boston, the wait is almost over on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Hockey is back from Beacons Ice Arena in Boston, Massachusetts. Let's check out the starting lineups for both of these clubs. First, the visiting William Smith Herons in their first ever NCAA game. At forward, Krista Federo, Kylie Fuster, and Morgan Bayreuther. On D, Grace Durham and Emily Burton. And in between the pipes, Margaret Salmon. It is a four-way competition in net for William Smith, and it seems as if head coach Jamie Totten is going to go with Maggie Salmon, the freshman from Medford, Massachusetts, to start off the NCAA career of William Smith. And now for the UMass Boston Beacons starting lineup.
Hi, I'm Sarah Leonardo. I'm a sophomore from Wilmington, Mass, and I'm a forward.
Hi, I'm Alexandra Carlos, senior from Parker, Colorado, forward.
My name's Lizzie Avison. I'm a sophomore from West Covina, California, and I play forward.
I'm Alexa Capion. I'm a junior from Messina, New York, and I'm a defenseman.
Hi, my name's Angela D'Andrio. I'm a senior from Swampscott, Massachusetts, and I'm a defenseman. Hi, I'm Moe Bradley. I'm a senior from Swampscott, Massachusetts, and I'm a goalie.
Puck has dropped and we're underway here on the campus of UMass Boston. Tyler Murray and Matt Meisenbacher with you live on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Thanks so much for being with us. About half a minute into play already. The Beacons on the offensive attack from behind the net. A pass out towards the front by Captain Alexandra Carlos is intercepted. And back the other way comes Krista Federo, the freshman from Niagara Falls, Ontario. We'll be saying the word freshman a lot for the Herons tonight because they're exclusively first-year players for William Smith. Beacons, as you can see, going from left to right on your screen, wearing the blue, white, and black uniforms. As for the Herons, they've got the green unis with that white numbering and lettering across the front.
And Tyler, it's going to be very important here for everyone to get a shift. Everyone's got the jitters. It's the first night. Everyone's going to want to get a shift under their belt, get some of that energy, and we should be good to go.
Down the near side is Lizzie Avison, just transferred from SUNY Plattsburgh, reigning NCAA Division III national champions. Shot on net is covered nicely. Puck is frozen. We're going to check out our player to watch today. In between the pipes for UMass Boston, that is going to be their senior from Swampscott, Moe Bradley, and she's been tremendous for the Beacons. Last year had a 50-save game. Just off the faceoff, it's tapped towards the net, but covered easily there by Maggie Salmon. And Matt, we've seen some very good things from Moe Bradley.
Yeah, Tyler, I mean, 373 shots last year, 23 goals against, 350 saves. That's enough said right there.
Beacons win the faceoff. Alyssa Sullivan gets it done, the senior from Medford, Massachusetts. Far side hash mark tumbles loose as Grace Durham gets the puck behind the net, gets rubbed up on from behind. Nicely done there. Kristen Embry works possession back for the Beacons, but a puck is loose once again on the far side corner. Beacons still putting on the pressure. You can see their experience having a factor early on here. Puck whapped in from the point by Kelsey McIsaac. The second pairing on defense is out there now, Armstrong and McIsaac. Behind the net, a good stick lift, a backhand shot. That was Sullivan on the near post, but couldn't get it angled towards the net. Tried to find Kat Armstrong on the point. Centering pass, backhand shot, rolling towards net. And that one's gobbled up by the goaltender, Maggie Salmon. Good backhand attempt right in the slot, but Salmon was ready for it.
Yeah, absolutely. We've seen some good shifts here by the Beacons. They're really dominating the offensive zone, and it seems to be, like you said, experience over the youth.
Now here comes Emily Howard's line. Jenny Curry's out there with Kayla Smith as well. There's a distant shot from Jenny Curry. Has some experience playing with Colgate earlier in her collegiate career. That certainly has helped the Beacons out during the last couple of years. Kayla Smith racing after it. Gets it from behind the net. Working for the puck. Looking to free it up there for Curry. She couldn't get the stick down. A four-player battle in the far corner, and the Beacons come away with it. This is Casey McGinley from distance, goes all the way through and by the boards. Near side, Salisbury couldn't pinch in and keep the puck from getting cleared away, but this one went all the way down without being touched. It's an icing, and we'll bring it back to the Beacons' offensive end as McGinley did well to chase that puck down. 17 minutes, 17 seconds to play in the first period. 0-0 the score. And the Beacons looking to build on what they accomplished last season. A 12-11-4 record overall. Quick shot off the faceoff by Salisbury. Couldn't get it to go. Quick reactions in net from Maggie Salmon and knocked it to the far side. Now Kayla Kiernan puts one behind the net. She's a senior from North Smithfield, Rhode Island. All the way back to the point, McGinley. To the circle. It's the lone freshman dressing today for the Beacons, Morissette, who set up McGinley for a dump pass inside. Now back near side, Salisbury, a pass across the box, hoping for Morissette, but Jean couldn't get there. Aaron's trying to clear, and they do. Maybe a chance this time. Kelly Fuster off to the races, winds up for a slapper from distance, but Salisbury gets the body on it and avoids a troublesome experience in net for Moe Bradley.
It's a great block there.
Now here comes Sarah Garrett just off the bench. She gets dispossessed. Into the near side it goes. It's Salisbury up ahead to Morissette. Nice slip pass right towards the middle of the ice for Kayla Kiernan, but no numbers and a line change. She'll dump this one behind.
Beacons want to be careful here, Tyler. A lot of offensive pressure, but let's not forget there's another zone, the D zone.
No doubt about it. They certainly have faith in Moe Bradley in between the pipes, but a good back line always helps. Nice player there by Angela D'Andrio. Got the start this evening. Back out there once again with her defensive pairing partner, Alexa Capione. Beacons getting the puck across the blue line without too much trouble here. Now a chance in the slot. Kick save made by Salmon. That was Sarah Alinardo right on net, but couldn't get it past the goaltender. Now behind the net, centering pass for Alinardo, deflects off of a Heron skate and winds up in the crease. Easy play there for Salmon, but the Beacons possessing very well so far, Matt.
Yeah, absolutely. Great work in the corners. Definitely winning the puck battles and finding that slot. Really, really great job by the Beacons so far.
Now they can get into the offensive zone. It's a matter, I think, of setting up those plays to find clean shots, and that'll certainly come with time. We heard from the captain, Alexandra Carlis, in our season preview during the pregame show. She wants the team to buy in to Coach Harris's system early on this year. Last season had a very slow November to start the year and then won 9 games in a row, so hopefully they can find their groove early on this season, as it's tracked down behind the net by Capione. In front of her own net, lost the puck, but fortunately for the Beacons, Lizzie Winegas couldn't put it towards the goal. A spin and a pass there by Sullivan, hoping to connect with Michaela Feya, the junior from Malden, Massachusetts. Loose puck in the neutral zone, slapped toward the near side boards by D'Andrea. That goes all the way down for the icing, and it'll be an offensive zone faceoff upcoming for the Herons.
And Tyler, you mentioned it before, everyone's new here. No one knows each other, so what's going to happen is the Beacons are going to have to figure it out as they go. There's no tendencies, there's no playbook. They're going to have to stick to the game plan and work through.
It's been a tall task for Herons head coach Jamie Totten. She helped the UConn Huskies women's hockey program develop from just club to D1 varsity as an assistant several years ago. Certainly, I think, a good pick to lead this team in its first Division III contest and Division III season, and hopefully for her, many more to come. This is Michaela Feya trying to get it out of her own zone, but couldn't do so. This one's dumped around by Grace Durham, a freshman from St. James, New York. Near side point, quick wrister, dangerous rebound in front, knocked away by Bradley, still loose, bounced out of the crease. Excellent job there by Bradley, and somehow Sullivan comes away with it. I'll tell you, Mizey, best chance of the game, maybe for either team, just went to William Smith.
Tyler, this is what I'm talking about. A lot of great offensive pressure, but we've seen some mistakes early on. That's a great save there by Moe Bradley. Really bailed the team out.
Had to go down on all fours for a moment, and a good job by the blue liners to head back and keep it out of trouble. Center ice faceoff. That's Emily Howard over the blue line. She's got Smith in front. Her shot goes wide, wrapping around to the near side. Knocked around here. It's Kat Armstrong. Squirts one up ahead for Smith, has it on the backhand, high slot, leaves one back for McIsaac, whose shot got deflected, but still Howard able to tip it ahead. This is Jenny Curry, the junior from Chelmsford, Massachusetts, tried to slip a defender but couldn't get around the crafty Andy Plumeri. This one is zipped into the corner, bounces around, the Herons come away with it. Nice pass up ahead, finding Plumeri, but she couldn't corral it cleanly, and the Beacons have a chance to counterattack with that indirect pass. Splits Curry and Howard, and it goes all the way down. It'll be an icing once again against William Smith. Good back and forth action here so far. Plenty of chances about 6.5 minutes in, but still no goals.
Yeah, I hope the Beacons didn't underestimate William Smith here. I know these girls can play, and like you mentioned, the coach knows what she's doing. I'm sure she's done a good job recruiting, so I hope the Beacons are prepared tonight.
You can imagine the mentality for William Smith. Nothing to lose, I think, is what I would come in with. Got to be such an exciting time to be able to play your first NCAA hockey game, and there's a booster club out front for the Herons. They've certainly come in to support their team as a slap shot off of the faceoff is knocked away. Off the stick of Kayla Kiernan, but a shoulder save by the goaltender Maggie Salmon. And now a whistle blows on the far side. Hand pass, it looked like. It's going to go back to the neutral zone for a faceoff. 13 minutes, 28 seconds left to go. My name's Tyler Murray. Happy to be joined by former Beacons men's hockey goalie Matt Meisenbacher. I bet you can't tell it's his first time on the radio, folks. I certainly can't. This one is dumped in.
I was always a talker, Tyler, always a talker.
Fans listening at home and seeing him here in person alike, very happy to have him on the broadcast, and you can count me in there as well, as Jess Salisbury tries to dump one along the near side boards, but it's deflected out towards the center circle. The freshman, Jean Morissette, will knock it over towards Casey McGinley. McGinley near side center ice for Samantha Fallon, who we talked about in the pregame show, leading this team with 16 goals. Fallon and the goaltender Moe Bradley, the first New England Hockey Writers Association All-Stars in Beacons history, named just last year. Pretty impressive pairing, and when you have talent, you'd love to spread it around the roster. A standout in goal and a standout at forward as this one goes all the way towards the goaltender Salmon, who for my money has looked pretty good in net so far.
She's been strong. She looks good. She's had a lot of good saves. Her rebounds look good, and I think she's definitely going to need to keep it up as her team gets acquainted on the ice.
And in some ways, Mizey, I'm sure you can relate. Maybe it's fun when you get a lot of shots thrown your way, but after a while, you're hoping to even the score a little bit, but always want to be active in net.
She's definitely getting in the groove, but I'm sure a break coming her way soon. I'm sure she's hoping.
Now, D'Andrio gets caught up at the blue line, but fortunately for her, she's got some help behind. It's her defensive partner, Capione, to track it down. Good pressure from behind put on there by Catherine Linehan. Linehan nearly freed it up for a teammate at the near side circle, but instead it's wrapped all the way around the other side, and here comes UMass Boston. A long distance dump from Alinardo. Funky bounce behind the net. Sarah nearly got there quickly to get it herself, but no luck that time. Now the captain, Carlos, the senior from Parker, Colorado, gets tangled up along the near side corner, but back all the way around again to Alinardo. Her pass bounces through the slot, picked up near side by Linehan, who's been active ever since coming back off the bench. D'Andrio with it now, 11 and a half minutes to go in the opening period of the 2014-2015 season. UMass Boston hosting William Smith. Good job there by Sullivan. Nearly kept it inside the blue line for an offensive chance on a turnover opportunity, but couldn't complete the steal. Back near side it comes. This is Plumeri from Margate, New Jersey. She has it taken away. The Beacons send it all the way down. Could be close. The icing arm is up, and getting there first is Durham of the Herons. So we'll bring it all the way back down.
Tyler, I think what we're seeing here, the Beacons are almost on a level where they're out playing, they're out skating, but the passing has been off a bit. I think that just comes first game of the season. People are holding the stick a little tight. I think as the game goes on, we might see that improve.
It's interesting. We'll get a chance tomorrow to see how these two teams adjust to each other. They're playing again, and for better or for worse, we'll be back on the broadcast with you at 4 p.m. right after the men's hockey opener on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Here comes Kelsey McIsaac, the senior from Durham, New Hampshire. Slips one through. Behind the net goes Sullivan. Can she get there first? Got a stick down on it, but it winds up behind her. Flips one up into the air. Now back behind her, it's McIsaac once again down deep. Centering pass from Sullivan, and it got behind Michaela Fea. Maybe had a chance at it, but she got tangled up in the slot. Plumeri sneaks one through. All the way around it goes behind Moe Bradley. Kat Armstrong fights for it, and Sarah Garrett backhands it into no man's land, picked up by Sullivan. She's got Fea near side, but instead she'll dump it down and get a line change. It'll be Jenny Curry coming out to lead the way with Kat Armstrong in there as well. Emily Howard and Kayla Smith join the fray as well. And to round out the five, it's Jess Salisbury on the back line joining Armstrong. This one's wrapped in by Howard. A chance here in front. This is Curry with a near side wrister. Couldn't get it to go, though. Another good save by Salmon. Tough angle. Shot finds the back of the net. And the Beacons take a 1-0 lead.
Great shot there. I mean, Beacons are just crashing the net. You could have seen this coming. Maggie was holding a minute for as long as she could, but the Beacons have pretty much been all over them for the entire period.
23, Emily Howard, the senior from Terryville, Connecticut, got the shot off. I couldn't see if it was deflected in front, Matt, but the Beacons will take it either way.
I think that's going to be Howard's goal, and I look like a genius. I mentioned her in the pregame, and here she is scoring. She makes me look good.
Good start for Visey on the broadcast. 10 minutes to go in the opening period. UMass Boston looking for more. Another tough angle shot that time from the freshman Morissette, and that time Salmon was ready for it. He's got the puck again in the far side corner. Has some options to pass at the point, but dumps it right back in on the back end.
Yeah, Tyler, as you can see here, Beacon's definitely trying to work that sidewall, work the corner, and I think you're going to see a lot of offensive production with that.
The goal will go to Emily Howard, and Kayla Smith gets the assist. So a good debut for her, just transferring from Salve Regina. Last season, Smith had 5 goals and 6 assists as a freshman. So as you see on your screen, 1 goal for Howard, 1 assist for Smith, and a 1-0 lead for the Beacons as they'll have a defensive zone faceoff down to our left. It's won by Morissette. Impressive stuff early on from the freshman. Bouncing puck towards center ice on the far side boards, winds up in the Beacons end where it's kicked by Salisbury, pass near side, where she's able to find Morissette, but the puck winds up on the stick of Johanna Slicklin, a freshman from Needham, Massachusetts. Johanna spells her name with a J, but you pronounce it softly. It comes near side for Samantha Fallon. Fallon goes off the boards for Kayla Kiernan, who has no option except to send it all the way down. Nice job to get past the red line to avoid an icing call as the Beacons get some fresh legs out there. Good forecheck pressure put on as Rebecca Begley can't quite clear it. Near side, this is the captain, Carlos, who sets up a slap shot near side from the defenseman, Alexa Capione, but the junior can't elude the goaltender, Salmon. It'll be a faceoff for the Beacons right by the net, though.
Yeah, that was a great shot there by Capione. She got all of that one for sure, and that's a good stop by Salmon, no rebound.
Capione did have one goal last season, a total of 4 points because she added three assists as well. And her lone goal last season, Capione, was a game winner against St. Michael's on January 25th, earlier in 2014. The Herons still putting on the forecheck pressure. Good to see, not falling back into a shell after trailing now as a wrister from the near side goes wide. Carlos getting aggressive, as you like to see. The captain showing some good speed and good agility out there. Backhanded pass into the middle by Alinardo, knocked right back towards her. This one goes high off the glass at the blue line. Nice touch there to create an opportunity. Here comes Federo, but a nice recovery by Avison to clear that one wide. A twirling pass goes all the way through the crease, and it's taken away by the Beacons.
Again, got to be careful. Let's not forget about that D zone.
Loose puck in the middle. Backhand thwap at it by Avison. It winds up on the stick of Angela D'Andrea, who just sends it all the way down. Line change for the Beacons. Sprinting onto the ice comes Kristen Embry. Embry, the sophomore from Highlands Ranch, Colorado. This one is sent in high to the far corner as Embry is joined out there by Alyssa Sullivan and Michaela Fea. At the back, you've got Kelsey McIsaac and Kat Armstrong. 7 minutes left in the first period. 1-0 UMass Boston on a goal from Emily Howard and an assist to Kayla Smith. This is McIsaac, takes it in stride. Far side hash marks will go beyond the red line all the way behind the net. Leaves one, and this is Michaela Fea trying to get it free off the backhand. Now forehands a pass from distance. Embry sends one on, but it goes wide. Deflects near side. Armstrong sprinting after it. Knocked it up ahead, hoping to find Michaela Fea, but no, it goes off her stick right towards the center ice marker, where it's flicked ahead by Kelsey McIsaac to prevent a transition opportunity for William Smith.
Tyler, I think what you're seeing here is the Beacons look very prepared, a lot of senior leadership, and I think they're handling the season opener a bit more. William Smith, not just their season opener, but their all-time opener, which I think is playing a factor here in the first period.
And as we said, it's a roster full of freshmen. And if the score stays this close, I think no moral victories, of course, but in Division III women's hockey, but you have to give some credit, I think, to William Smith for keeping it close. And we've seen at least one grade A chance from their team in front. If not for a great save by Moe Bradley, this could be a tie game right
now. Absolutely.
Centering pass intercepted by Alyssa Sullivan behind her own net. Knocks one up ahead where it's picked up by Jenny Curry. Has it taken away after a brief possession by Andy Plumeri. Plumeri's been active so far. Like what I see from her as this one goes again near side to Curry. Plumeri's there again to make it difficult for the Beacons to clear the zone. Now Kelsey McIsaac finds the space, fakes the dump near side, still has a puck on her stick, beautifully done. She has a teammate right in the middle. That's Curry. She gets hammered behind the net. No call made. They're letting them play this evening in the season opener.
Tyler, that was a good hit in a men's game.
It comes near side. Kelsey McIsaac, a pretty nifty backhand dump all the way around. Jenny Curry with it towards the corner. Try to slip one back towards the point, but no Beacons are there. It's picked up by Plumeri once again. Her pass to the opposite end is picked up by Abigail Symes, but she gets pinned up against the boards, knocked away by Smith. Offsides warning was there, but the Beacons touch it first, so we'll play on. Now it's Emily Howard. Cross-ice pass off the boards, beautifully placed, and Curry can pick it up in stride. Her shot knocked away, nearly got that one past Salmon, but when she's seen the puck, she stopped it, and the Beacons will get a face-off right by the net.
Tyler, I got to give it to her. She looks good. No, rebounds have been good, and other than the one from Emily Howard, she's had a pretty solid first period.
Just over 5 minutes left to go in this first period. 1-0 Beacons. The goal, as Matt Meisenbacher just told you, went to Emily Howard, assisted by Kayla Smith. As we said, Smith, a transfer from Salve Regina, had 6 assists all of last year as a freshman. Sent in by Sam Fallon on the backhand, handled there easily by Rebecca Begley. But can the Herons clear? That's been the question all day long. Looking for a transition feed up ahead to Morgan Bayreuther, but it's knocked away at the point of attack by Jess Salisbury. This puck is chipped up ahead. Maybe a chance for Federer. One-on-one with the goaltender. Backhanded shot at stonewalled by Bradley.
There she is, Tyler. I mean, you figure after a period, she's been down there by herself all alone, and that's a great save there, keeping it 1-0.
Mo says no, her toughest effort of the day. It goes near side to Sam Fallon, but it's just out of her reach. William Smith is not just satisfied to be a Division III program, Matt. They're ready to win this game if they can keep these goal-scoring opportunities coming.
I would agree. That's the third time now we've seen them in the zone, and they have potential to score here. Beacons better be careful.
They certainly do not take Moe Bradley for granted. She has experience playing Division I college hockey with the University of New Hampshire. Had a 50-save game last year, eighth in the country in 2013-2014 with a 93.8 save percentage and allowed just 1.5 goals per game, good for 11th in all of Division III. So certainly a sung hero. She's very much known around these parts for helping the Beacons out to a big season last year, and hopefully she can keep it going if you're a Beacons fan.
Tyler, I didn't have those numbers in practice, let alone a game.
Always humble, Matt Meisenbacher, the former standout goalie from these UMass Boston Beacons, the men's side anyway, as Capione takes it in her own end, 3.5 minutes to go in the opening period, 1-0 UMass Boston. Emily Howard scored the goal on an assist from Kayla Smith. That's the top line of forwards that we've seen from Colleen Harris's club. Harris, in her fifth season, graduated Boston College in 2009, so she knows how to succeed in women's hockey, that's for sure. And an interesting tidbit about the season for Harris, it's her first season when every person on this roster was recruited by Colleen. She had a great first season as an interim coach. The team had double-digit wins, but last year was their first in quite a while getting over that double-digit hump, over 500 in the regular season, and of course just one goal away in overtime from making the conference championship, as here comes Embry, but her shot's knocked away.
And Tyler, there's no doubt she's proud about this group. This is her first recruiting class, and I believe they have high expectations on the season.
Decent chance in front with Embry hitting one towards the slot, but a nice job by Fuster to intercept, and she whips one all the way towards net, and Bradley knocks it towards the corner. Turnover for the Beacon. Centering pass just gets to the skates. Back come the Herons. A shot from distance knocked down off the stick of Grace Durham, but it's still loose behind the net. McIsaac picks up for UMass Boston, and she'll turn back and find some clear space where her partner Kat Armstrong gives it right back to her. 2 minutes to go in the first period. Beautiful pass to clear the zone. It goes from Embry all the way near side, where she finds Michaela Feya. Her shot knocked away with a blocker. Nicely done there by Maggie Salmon. Can't overlook what she's been able to do so far this evening.
And another good save, rebound in the corner. I think a penalty here on William Smith.
It certainly looked like a trip, an all-out full extension dive to hopefully free up that puck, but the referee's all over it, and we'll see who heads to the box. It's going to be Grace Durham and our first power play of the game. We talked about this in the pregame, Matt. The key's going to be, in a lot of ways, taking advantage of these opportunities, especially against a young team like William Smith.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's a good chance here for the power play. End of a period. They want to end on a high note. Let's see if they can put one more in before the buzzer.
Face off won by Howard. We're getting the first look at the Beacons power play one unit as McIsaac sends on from distance, but it's knocked away in the slot. It comes near side. This is Jenny Curry behind the net for Howard. Curry gets it right back. At the circle hash marks, this is Sullivan. Top of the point. It goes to the captain, Carlos. Carlos near side circle, McIsaac centering pass deflected around, dangerous in front. Is Salmon ready in between the pipes? It doesn't matter just yet, it's cleared away. McIsaac winds up a distance slap shot, kicked wide, and picked up by Howard in the corner. Cycling in front, a backhand pass to the far circle. Carlos sends one directly on net, and a good save again by Maggie Salmon.
Yeah, the Beacons seem to be working the points here. You saw Carlos, you saw McIsaac. I think the idea is feed the point, crash the net. Pretty simple, but tough on the tender.
Five pairs of fresh skates out there for the Beacons. It'll be Morissette, Fallon, Embry, and at the back you see Kat Armstrong, along with Kayla Kiernan. This shot's deflected too high, as Morissette did well to get a stick on that one, but could not put it goalward, so another stoppage in play. 58 seconds left in the period, and a minute 12 left in the power play.
As long as the D have enough room, they might as well take those shots. If that's what they're gonna get, take what you're given.
Another face-off won by Morissette. It comes to Kiernan. She's a forward playing back on D in this power play setup. Nice backhand pass by Morissette, but a bit too hard for Embry to corral it. This is Armstrong, has an opportunity. This shot is just a bit wide from the far circle. Still possessed, though, by Morissette behind the net. Chance to clear for the Herons, but a nice job to keep it in as Armstrong possesses now. Has some options, so go to her left. Centering pass off the stick of Embry, knocked away in the slot, and this one's cleared all the way down.
I like what I'm seeing here by the Beacons. Good puck movement, getting shots through. It's a good start.
Jane Morissette, the freshman, has certainly stood out, I think, with all the young players in this game. And here she goes again, tracking one down in the far corner. No icing is the call. Puck knocked away momentarily, but still, Johanna Slicklund is able to knock it towards the blue line. This is Morissette. Out to the point it goes. Armstrong sets up Kiernan. Her shot deflected home. 2-0 UMass Boston. It was a near side shot from Kiernan. Fallon maybe got a piece of that. Either way, it's 2-0 Beacons with 3 seconds to go in the first period.
Yeah, tough to tell there, Tyler. Definitely a shot from the point. I think Fallon may have gotten a piece. Like I said, tough to tell, but exactly what the Beacons needed. 3 seconds left on the clock. There's your second goal, and now they have a little bit of breathing room going in after the first period.
It's going to be officially ruled a goal for Kayla Kiernan. No tip in for Samantha Fallon, but Mizey, she did her job screening the goalie there.
Yeah.
And keeping off the vision. I'm sure you know how tough that is.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there's no doubt about it. Goalie has to pay attention to the person in front, and Kiernan did a great job getting it through.
Just 3 seconds to go in period number one. It is 2-0 UMass Boston, and barring some kind of fluky play, this should just wind down the clock as Capione sends it towards the near corner, and the Beacons head to the locker room having to feel very good about what they were able to do. Matt, give me a quick breakdown of what you saw in the first period of the season.
Yeah, Tyler, I mean, you can't really ask more there for the Beacons. They pretty much dominated in the offensive zone. They look really strong. I'm going to hold them to a higher standard. I think I would have liked to see some more crisper passes, and the defensive zone at times looked a little porous, so I think they need to tighten things up a bit, but overall a solid period for the Beacons.
Let's give some credit to William Smith, though, especially their goaltender Maggie Salmon looked very solid, and we saw two, if not three, chances for them to tie this game up when it was 1-0 Beacons, but Moe Bradley was a stonewall when she had to be.
Yeah, absolutely. I think you can't really fault Maggie on either of the goals. She looked good. Her rebounds were solid, and to be honest, she's really holding her team in it. I think going in after the first period as a program, pretty happy with that type of performance.
Now, if you're Colleen Harris right now, the head coach for the Beacons, you've seen them play very well. It's certainly on the scoreboard, 2-0. How would you approach the second and third periods going forward? Do you want to see them keep putting on the pressure and, I don't want to say running up the score, but making sure your skates are underneath you and set to go for this exciting 2014-15 season? Or do you want to play a little more conservatively going forward? I don't think this is the wrong answer, Matt, but what would you do if you were Colleen Harris?
I mean, going forward, I would definitely think she's going to want to keep going. A two-goal lead can be very dangerous in hockey, and they look good in the offensive zone. I think what she's going to want to see is consistency. Everyone's got a period under their belt now, and I think moving forward, definitely better in the D zone. Let's not rely totally on Mo. She's going to be there. But let's keep doing what we're doing and make sure that in the offensive zone we can continue to stick to the script and not deviate from the plan.
You can see the score there, 2-0. UMass Boston has the lead on goals from Emily Howard and Kayla Kiernan, both coming from a pretty good distance away, as the Beacons able to solve Maggie Salmon just twice. And now we can take a look, if you missed it in the pregame show, at the Beacons season preview. Pretty impressive and insightful stuff from some of their star players and their coach, and some good highlights from what we saw during practice and in preseason games here. Here is the Beacons season preview.
It definitely still hurts the ending of our last season, but it just showed that we can do it. And in beating those top teams, it gave us a lot of confidence, and I think that helped us in the end come as close as we did.
Now we clearly know we can do it. It gave us a lot of confidence going into this year and a huge chip on our shoulders knowing that we're coming for other teams, and I think other teams should be a little nervous for what we have coming this year.
It would mean a lot to us because we've all been working hard together the past 4 years. The ones remaining stuck it out. We're still here. We know we have to work hard, and that's our main goal. It's our last year. We really want to win that championship.
After Norwich, I think it's going to be great to start out at home. We're playing a new team. We can't take them for granted, that's for sure, but it's definitely going to help us and give us more confidence with our crowd and get the excitement going for our home game. They've been great so far. Ron in the gym, he's We've never been this strong before in my 3 years here. We're lifting a ton of weight. We're stronger than ever. Taylor, our new assistant coach, she's awesome. She ran a few practices. She's doing great, giving us some awesome new drills.
We need to buy in right away. Last year it took too long to buy into coaches' systems and know that they actually work. But this year, I believe, with all the returners, we can jump on that right away and really get after it.
I think Mo is going to be unreal this year, just as she was last year. She's been big for us in net previously, so I think she's going to be great. Burke and Casey, they're going to be right there with her. They all look good in preseason, so we're excited to see them in net. I think this year's defense is going to be just as great as last year. We're all returners, actually. We're not getting anyone new, so we're strong. We know our defensive zone pretty well, so I think it's going to be great.
Well, we lost a few forwards that definitely had major roles on the team. The younger kids are definitely stepping up. We have 7 new people. They're all going to play a big role. We're all mixing together well.
We've got some returners that are standing out extremely. Jess Salisbury's standing out. She's stepped up a lot this year. As far as new people, Sarah Alinardo, she's stepped up. She is doing really well right now. Lizzie Aveson, Jane, they're all quick players, good hands, smart players.
Playing those kinds of teams gives us confidence. Like, we tied the team from Minnesota. We knew they were a good team. It boosted our confidence. It lets us know that we can and we will be anyone to get to the championship.
We're definitely looking forward to Codfish, but I think we're also looking forward to getting some revenge on Norwich and those other big teams such as Holy Cross and St. A's that we're always head-to-head with, so playing them is definitely going to be one of our biggest priorities. Definitely want to win a championship and just come together as a team.
Win a championship.
We just want to win a championship. We came so far last year, and that really hurt. So I think everyone's going to carry that with them this season, and hopefully we come out on top.
Needless to say, it should be a very exciting and entertaining 2014-2015 season for the Beacons women's hockey team. We'll take a quick look at the stats from the first period of play. We saw the goals from Emily Howard at 9:58 and Kayla Kiernan at 19:57. And a quick update, folks. Yes, Kayla Smith got the assist on the first goal. Kat Armstrong is going to be given an assist on the second goal, so a pretty good showing early on from UMass Boston. You see the overall stats there. And I think, to William Smith's credit, it's a lot closer on the ice in terms of good opportunities than the total shots show. The Beacons certainly have dominated possession, but William Smith had 2 chances, I think, to score, if not for Moe Bradley in net. And you can imagine how tough it must be for lots of freshmen taking on a senior goaltender in Moe Bradley, who's had experience with the University of New Hampshire, of course, a very well-respected Division I program. And the power play goal is one of our keys to the game we talked about earlier, and we're going to rehash that later on in the pregame show. Beacons able to take advantage of their lone power play. That was the goal knocked in by Kayla Kiernan from distance as UMass Boston was able to double their lead to 2-0. So the Beacons do lead by a couple, about 8.5 minutes to go until we get to second period play. We'll take a commercial break, so stay with us on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
Division 3 allows you to give yourself to other things.
Having that free time allows me to pursue the things that I want to pursue.
Division 3 athletics affords students the opportunity to, you know, engage in the other interests in their campus and in their lives outside of that sport.
It allows you to just be able to do everything you want to do. I wouldn't change it for the world.
My name is Allie Greenberg. I'm an ice hockey player here. I'm a junior majoring in human services, and I'm part of the Key for Hope Foundation. We recycle the keys and stock food pantries with the money. I wanted to bring this foundation to the athletic department, and I believe we can end hunger starting at UMass Boston. I got started with the Key for Hope Foundation due to my father. He's the one who founded this program.
I said, what can I do with a classroom environment giving back? And everybody's got an old key, and keys are made of brass, and brass is a recyclable commodity. and thinking about how many children are in a school system and how far we can go with taking this to do something right for humanity, I started a foundation called Key for Hope, feeding others with the collecting of keys. In 2.5 years, we collected over 500,000 keys. And I'm excited about this whole opportunity because you know what? One key may not seem like much to most people, but when you collect the masses of keys that we've collected, it shows that there is an ability for people to get together and create what I'm considering our hunger fighting opportunity.
Back live at Beacons Ice Arena on the campus of UMass Boston, Tyler Murray and Matt Meisenbacher with you live. It is 2-0. UMass leads William Smith, and William Smith, as we've said, playing in its first ever NCAA collegiate competition. So congratulations to them. They've certainly impressed early on. Doesn't show on the scoreboard just yet, but it should be an exciting finish going forward. And let's take a look at William Smith. They're in Geneva, New York, and we talked about their head coach, Jamie Totten, in her first season, of course. She was a big help for the UConn Huskies' former club women's hockey team, bringing them to Division I just a couple of seasons ago. Very exciting, I'm sure, for her to bring this new team into Division III play, as she was very excited before today's game to get this one underway. And as we said, her team has played quite well, and now with the addition of both hockey and volleyball, William Smith now has 13 NCAA sports to offer, so certainly excited for them and happy to be a part of their inaugural game in program history. Let's check out what's going on around Beaconville. We have a pretty fun video to show you during the second intermission. Don't go away, because Krista Layden was on SportsCenter for the women's soccer team a couple of days ago in the top 10. But checking out what's going on soon, the volleyball team is at Emory University for the Emory University Invitational. The Beacons have had a pretty solid season in volleyball, looking to get their third straight regular season championship in the Little East, but they've definitely had some adversity as of late. Hopefully they can continue to excel. Men's hockey hosting UMass Dartmouth tomorrow at 1. We'll have that call for you. And the women's hockey team is going to be hosting this same William Smith Club at 4 o'clock tomorrow. Now, men's soccer has a senior day tomorrow at noon, and women's soccer is on the road at RIC, Rhode Island College, tomorrow at 1 o'clock. So a lot going on, including the cross-country team competing in the LEC Championship game at 11 a.m. tomorrow in North Adams, Massachusetts. That's up near Merrimack. Let's check out what's going on in the rest of the ECAC. Not too many scores to report at the moment. Nichols defeated Stevenson 2-0, and you can see all the other games coming up as the evening goes on. A lot of fun, a good time to be a hockey fan. We are in full swing on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Just 20 minutes of hockey in the books. Excited to bring some more for you in just a bit. Let's take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we'll be right on the doorstep of period number 2. This is the Beacons Broadcast Network.
My name is Allie Greenberg. I'm an ice hockey player here. I'm a junior majoring in human services, and I'm part of the Key for Hope Foundation. We recycle the keys and stock food pantries with the money. I wanted to bring this foundation to the athletic department, and I believe we can end hunger starting at UMass Boston. I got started with the Key for Hope Foundation due to my father. He's the one who founded this program.
I said, what can I do with a classroom environment giving back? And everybody's got an old key, and keys are made of brass, and brass is a recyclable commodity. And thinking about how many children are in a school system and how far we can go with taking this to do something right for humanity, I started a foundation called Key for Hope, feeding others with the collecting of keys. In 2.5 years, we collected over 500,000 keys. And I'm excited about this whole opportunity because you know what? One key may not seem like much to most people, but when you collect the masses of keys that we've collected, it shows that there is an ability for people to get together and create what I'm considering our hunger fighting opportunity.
As usual, she wins it. A chance in front. Her shot is in the net. Crystal Layden, yet another goal.
Please make a gift to the Beacon Athletic Fund today. We want you on our team.
My name's Allie Greenberg. I'm an ice hockey player here. I'm a junior majoring in human services, and I'm part of the Key for Hope Foundation. We recycle the keys and stock food pantries with the money. I wanted to bring this foundation to the athletic department, and I believe we can end hunger starting at UMass Boston. I got started with the Key for Hope Foundation due to my father. He's the one who founded this program.
I said, what can I do with a classroom environment giving back? And everybody's got an old key, and keys are made of brass, and brass is a recyclable commodity. And thinking about how many children are in a school system and how far we can go with taking this to do something right for humanity, I started a foundation called Key for Hope, feeding others with the collecting of keys. In 2.5 years, we collected over 500,000 keys. And I'm excited about this whole opportunity because you know what? One key may not seem like much to most people, but when you collect the masses of keys that we've collected, it shows that there is an ability for people to get together and create what I'm considering our hunger fighting opportunity.
1 minute away from puck drop in period number two. Thanks for sticking with us through our intermission report. It's 2-0 UMass Boston. Tyler Murray and Matt Meisenbacher with you live on the Beacons Broadcast Network. And Matt, you saw a lot of positives from both of these goaltenders in the first period. Why don't you break it down for us? Maggie Salmon and Moe Bradley, both looking very strong.
Yeah, absolutely. I think you're seeing two opposites here. Maggie came into the game. She had a very active period. She really kept her team in it. She had a lot of good saves. Gave up two, but her rebounds looked really strong, which is a good sign. And to be honest, as a goaltender, getting in a groove like that can be very beneficial going forward in the game. On the reverse, Moe Bradley, three great saves in the period. It's tough when you're not seeing a lot of action to stay mentally into it, but she was able to do that. And honestly, that breakaway save was fantastic, along with that rebound in front.
The goals both coming from UMass Boston at even strength at 9:58. Emily Howard assisted by Kayla Smith. And then at 19:57, that's right, with 3 seconds left in the first period, Kayla Kiernan scored from the near side point, assisted by Kat Armstrong. That was a power play goal. And the Beacons will start the second period with a 2-0 lead. As you can see, now going from right to left across your computer screen in the black, blue, and white, with the visiting William Smith Herons in the green going left to right. Behind the net, this is UMass Boston up ahead to Sarah Alinardo. Nearly created an opportunity for Grace Durham, whose shot went just a little bit wide. Beacons couldn't control at center ice. This one's knocked away. It comes near side to Lizzie Avison. Nearly made a nice stick move to get towards the middle of the slot for a wrister, but couldn't get it away cleanly. Now here comes Alexandra Carlis, the captain, but has the puck taken away, as William Smith has been very active with their sticks and poke checks so far in this one. They've certainly done well to keep this just a 2-0 deficit so far, especially having been outshot 16-2 in the first period.
Yeah, absolutely. And Tyler, most deadly lead in hockey, a 2-goal lead. Let's be careful.
We've heard that before, absolutely, as the Beacons will keep the pressure on as best they can. Dumped in there by Kristen Embry. Unable to be collected, though, by Michaela Faya. Comes all the way back near side for Kelsey McIsaac. A long pass to the far end for Faya, just out of her reach. And racing after it is Hedy Drosty. Drosty, the freshman, of course, from Newfields, New Hampshire. McIsaac winds up and fires from distance, but it's deflected away, and Armstrong will just dump this one in. Beacons will get a couple of players off the ice as on comes Jenny Curry, and she's joined by Emily Howard. At the back, you see McIsaac, who's joined by Armstrong. Curry couldn't pinch well and make a hit on the near side, so it's knocked in towards the goaltender. Loose puck behind the net. Stick towards the near side boards into the corner by Sullivan. Centering pass, hoping to find Howard, eludes her, and it goes all the way down. No icing is the call, though, so we'll keep on playing. 2 minutes into period number two, still 2-0 UMass Boston. To the point it goes, McIsaac keeps it alive inside the Beacons' offensive area, all the way around for Emily Howard. Howard leaves one for Kayla Smith, who had the assist on the Howard goal earlier this game. Centering pass, looking down the middle for Jenny Curry, but she couldn't quite get a stick down.
Tyler, I've been impressed with McIsaac. She's made a lot of good plays. She's had a few good shots from the point. Some of them have been blocked, but she's looked strong so far.
Very good puck possessor and a puck-moving defenseman, always important to have on any squad. That's McIsaac, the senior from Durham, New Hampshire. Armstrong fighting for it near side, gets tangled up with both Linehan and Birmingham, and somehow Linehan came away with it, momentarily anyway, and there's McIsaac again to possess. She'll get it up towards her teammate, Kayla Kiernan. Cat Armstrong finds Kiernan. Now across the blue line, this is Emily Howard, whose shot is deflected away. If William Smith had found a clean getaway path, they might have caught the Beacons on a change there, but a good job by those backliners, Jess Salisbury, to get back there with Casey McGinley. It'll come near side now for Jenny Curry. This pass is deflected around. A chance for Fallon, whose airborne shot gets knocked around. Rebound shot is kicked away again. Behind the net it goes for the freshman, Jane Morissette. From distance, McGinley snaps one towards goal, but Maggie Salmon's ready for it, and she'll make another save.
And Tyler, I know we're only 4.5 in here, but I think you're seeing a lot more even play. I think William Smith has come out, maybe the jitters are gone, and they look to be a little more even with the Beacons so far this period.
And that's impressive for the Herons, because the Beacons now know what they need to do to get good scoring chances against Maggie Salmon. Take some shots from distance, work the puck around well, and as we saw on the goal from Kiernan, have big bodies like Sam Fallon in front to shield the goaltender from viewing the puck, but Salmon's been good and so has the defense.
Absolutely.
16 minutes to go in period number two. UMass Boston still has a 2-0 lead. This is Jess Salisbury, who gets hit heavily behind the net. This will be a penalty for sure against Kylie Fuster, who seemingly is showing immediate remorse as that was a nasty hit. You can see Salisbury is still down and didn't look to be intentional, but by the way of the law, that's certainly a penalty.
Yeah, Tyler, never want to see that. You know, a player, it's a physical game. Things like that are going to happen, and it doesn't look intentional, but, again, never want to see that type of play in hockey.
Now, Salisbury is certainly showing signs of movement, and they're going to get the trainer out there on the ice, but a wonderful sight to see. Salisbury up on her skates, and she'll be helped off, it looks like. It's a nice round of applause for the Beacon faithful. And a good mixed crowd here today, as the Herons faithful have come out as well. One of the better crowds we've seen in a couple recent games here on the campus of UMass Boston. The preseason games don't necessarily sell out, but obviously people in the Boston area excited for the return of D3 hockey. So 2 minutes on the penalty clock against the Herons. It's the second power play opportunity for UMass Boston so far in this game. They have not been in the penalty box themselves yet.
Tyler, you see McIsaac lining up here on the blue line. I think coach has noticed she's had some good opportunities getting the puck through, and I think you're going to see some more of that here.
She's at the back with Kayla Smith. That's Alexandra Carlos, actually, beg your pardon. Smith is into the corner right now, fighting for a puck with Sullivan, but they can't win the battle. Nice job there by Grace Durham to clear that one all the way down. Just 20 seconds gone in the second power play of the day for UMass Boston. They're 1-for-1 so far. This pass intercepted, though, as Durham once again becoming a factor on the penalty kill for William Smith.
She's been strong. That was a good read there on the breakout.
Always important to avoid those transition passes from being completed. The Beacons have so much speed and agility. Once they get past that blue line, sometimes they're tough to stop. As McIsaac brings it all the way down, lost her stick, so she'll either pick it up or just shield the puck. She does get the puck shielded enough to allow Sullivan to creep out with it. Top of the circle near side to McIsaac. Tough angle shot knocked around, and Salmon is ready for it. That one off the stick of Durham. A good deflection by her. And again, the goaltender ready for it.
Tyler, I think what might have happened here is Beacons are a little predictable now. They were working the puck off the wall and off the corner, but I think William Smith has adjusted, and they might need to readjust themselves and counter.
This is Morissette in the circle. Couldn't win it cleanly. It comes all the way out of bounds near side over the glass. Maybe a souvenir for a fan down there. 15 minutes to go in the second period and a minute left on the UMass Boston power play. Another faceoff for Morissette and Federo. It comes near side. Federo gets the win. It's cleared away by Rebecca Begley. Deflected off the gloves of Kayla Kiernan all the way down. And this one's kicked away. On a nice reaction by Moe Bradley, Ashley Birmingham was bearing down on her. Didn't get the best angle on the shot, though. Still a pretty good job by William Smith to keep the pressure on shorthanded. 38 seconds left in the power play. This is Samantha Fallon. She'll take it over the red line herself. Couldn't get through the blue line cleanly, and a whistle blows. Maybe offsides on UMass Boston.
I mean, Tyler, let's be honest here. This hasn't been a strong power play for the Beacons. Can't really break the puck out, having trouble on zone entry. They had a great first power play, but I don't know what happened.
It looks like maybe they're crashing the net a bit more this time around versus those shots from distance. But I can understand being conservative, because if you whiff on a shot from the point, you set up a shorthanded opportunity the other way.
You're right.
But mixing things up here early on, trying to find that groove as a near side wrister from Emily Howard, who scored the first goal in this game, is deflected away. This is bounced toward the far side point, kept alive by Carlos, trickling in towards the slot. It goes right back towards the point, beautifully done by Sullivan to keep it in the offensive zone, taking advantage of the width of that blue line. This is McIsaac. Her pass is knocked down, but right towards Sullivan. A backhanded pass bouncing through the slot. A little bit too choppy that time. It's teamed for Emily Howard, and it gets past her to the other side of the boards. Another bouncing pass inside. Centering pass looking for Carly. She couldn't get it off cleanly. Beacon still possessed. Smith on the wraparound. She gets denied by Salmon, and a near side roof job attempt by Sullivan is shouldered away. Once again, Maggie Salmon is there. Power play expires. The shot's blocked away once again. Sullivan trying to find that upper 90 on the near side, but can't quite get it past the goaltender. D to D it goes, cycling around. This is McIsaac. To her right, she's able to find Howard with her back to the net. Howard finds a teammate. That's Sullivan. She puts her back to the net on the backhand. She'll straighten up and dump this one around. A good read that time by Kayla Smith. But a transfer from Salve Regina has been active already today. Near the red line towards the near side corner, cycling around towards the circle. Down deep, she finds Howard. Howard has some space. Her shot kicked away. It winds up with Morissette. They love that near side circle right now, the Beacons do. That one sent in by D'Andrio. Couldn't get a deflection from Smith. It goes all the way around for Capione.
Great carryover pressure here by the Beacons. The power play wasn't as effective, but they picked up, they found a spark, and they've been in the offensive zone since.
Alinardo sets up a slap shot from the far circle. Capione couldn't get it past Salmon. Players flying to the ice here, but Morissette keeps her edge and goes near side, hoping for a point pass to D'Andrio, but no, it's picked off by Lizzie Winegas. She goes down, gets tangled up with Lizzie Avison. No call made, a good no call, I'd say. Incidental contact, and the Beacons keep the play alive. I like what you said there, Mizey, about keeping the pressure on once the power play ends, because the Herons did not get new legs out there to get some fresh energy and kill off that attempt, because all the pressure the Beacons had put on, you can imagine they were a bit tired.
Absolutely, and you can see the Beacons were changing. The Herons don't have that option. So very, very good pressure and carryover from the power play by the Beacons.
Johannes Slicklund finds Heidi Drosty at the point, but her shot's knocked away. D'Andrio falls down, though. Nearly a deke by Johannes Slicklund to free herself up, but it goes to the near side boards. Far side now, Sarah Alinaro. Sophomore from Wilmington, Massachusetts, gets it near side to D'Andrio. Plenty of time, and sends a soft pass to Lizzie Avison. Avison shot knocked down in front, and it looked like Garrett had a chance to turn it up towards the offensive end, but she loses the puck. This is Sullivan. Look at the moves. Backhanded shot. What a beauty. Alyssa Sullivan weaving magic in the offensive end. It's a 3-0 Beacon lead.
Wow. Wow. What a play by Sullivan there. Oh, my God. Off the wall. I think she went around three defenders, backhand upstairs underneath the bar. Tyler, I got to be honest. I don't know if I would have had that one.
I don't know if I could have done that in the video game. It was so impressive. 11 minutes, 31 seconds to go in the second period, almost halfway through this one, and we just saw the play of the game.
Apparently taking a page out of Patrick Kane's book. She must have been watching the highlight reel prior to the game.
I've seen that before on an NHL stage. I think you're right, Mizey. As this one's knocked around loose, maybe a response from William Smith, but that could be a tough one to come back from. Knocked around at center ice. Unassisted is the ruling on that Sullivan goal.
Great goal by Sullivan, but I do want to update. We saw Salisbury off. She had her helmet off, but she did walk to the locker room on her own 2 feet, which is good, so it's a good sign. I believe she's expected to return. We'll have to wait and see.
3-0 Beacons, and the way they've looked so far, they can afford to rest a maybe not 100% player, but you want to get everyone some ice time to get yourself acquainted to the new season, and the Beacons getting it off to a good start right now as Kat Armstrong possesses near side point. Got around one defender, that was Lizzie Winegas, but Lizzie did well to recover. She's got the puck now, quickly cut off though by McIsaac, and Winegas retaliates with a heavy hit on the near side boards, and yet again the Beacons will go to the power play.
Yeah, another great play there by McIsaac, intercepted the puck, and she definitely took a hit to make a play. She seems to be all right, and They're going to need her going forward.
Wine gas. I don't know if that was frustration, but definitely physical play. You like to see it, but that's just not in the rule book. You can't do that.
Well, here's the thing. The Sullivan goal was very pretty, and I think down 3-0 now, they might be a little bit frustrated and don't want to say that happened, but looked to be the case in that scenario.
Loose puck in the slot, picked up there by Hedy Drosty. So the Beacons going on the power play for the second time this period and the third time tonight. They are 1-for-2 so far, although their third goal came maybe a minute and a half after their last power play came to an end. So you can tell William Smith, the effort is there, but the fatigue factor, tough to deal with as Fallon shots kicked away. Winds up behind the net, Samantha will keep it. Cycling towards the near side, Dot Rister heading for the roof, knocked away by Maggie Salmon, and Fallon controls once again. Gets it back to Kiernan. This is Armstrong. Finds Kiernan plenty of space. Her shot looking for goal number two is knocked away. Fallon, very active on this power play. High slot, winds up for a slap shot deflected wide. It looked like Salmon didn't find it cleanly. Fortunately for William Smith, it didn't find the net either. Now this is Armstrong. Backhanded wrap around. Searching for it behind the net. This is Kristen Embry. Embry, the Colorado native, has some space near side, but couldn't get it away. Now Emily Howard just onto the ice, frees it up for Fallon. In that corner, she'll carry it in. Centering pass, bounced right back towards a rebound, knocked around and kicked away by Salmon. Now it looked like Howard got tangled up with the stick of Slicklin. Here's a slap shot from distance. It goes wide off of Armstrong's stick.
Beacon's doing a great job firing the puck here. And like I said before, William Smith has decided to pack the house and let him have the top. Beacons are taking advantage.
30 seconds left in the power play. This is the captain as Z has one knocked away. Pretty good accuracy on that snapshot, but no goal. Now Howard tried one from the near side dot, but she gets denied. A good block there by Slicklin.
That's a great keep there on the wall.
That was Howard to get it done. She's able to find Carlos, knocked one around, and Howard gets there again. Joined out there by Smith, McIsaac, and Embry. Quick wrister from Smith deflected back around the net and finally cleared down just as the power play expires by William Smith. That time Rebecca Begley got the job done. Maybe a momentum swing in favor of the Herons. Good centering pass that time from Federal, but nobody home.
Yeah, no goals there on the power play for the Beacons, but I'd give him an A overall. That was a solid power play.
Behind the net, this is Kayla Smith fighting for it. Got it away from Bayreuther to the other end behind the net. As McIsaac got tangled up with her own stick and skates, could not receive that pass. Kept it on the blue line for a moment, but knocked away by Smith, who shuffles one ahead to Howard. She'll just wrap this one around the boards. Didn't have space to skate in towards the slot and wisely got the line change. But Sullivan stayed out there, working hard for possession. Sullivan looking for another highlight reel play. Centering pass just gets past Alinardo, and it goes near side where Capione sends one towards the middle, deflected high in the air all the way to the opposite end. Under 8 minutes left to go in the middle period. 3-0, UMass Boston. Centering pass goes all the way through. It'll head to the opposite end of the ice, and the Beacons chase it down. Well, Sullivan clearly gained some confidence from that goal just a couple of minutes ago. We saw similar deking ability to free her up for a centering pass that time, but just couldn't connect.
Yeah, first game of the season. I guess the rust is off the hands, and here she is on a 2-on-1.
Centering pass, Alinardo denied. Rebound up and over the net. Sullivan couldn't quite convert on the second chance opportunity, but Maggie Salmon denied Alinardo on the first opportunity.
Tyler, got to give it to Salmon here. I mean, she's been holding the minute. The fact that it's still 3-0 is really a contribution to her.
I would agree. Deflected shot there off the stick of Alinardo, goes up high. And Capione had a good interception to find some space to shoot, but couldn't get it cleanly on the tip. Knocked around far side half boards on the backhand stick of Fea. She'll leave it behind her for Casey McGinley. And the Scottsdale, Arizona native will send it around and get off the ice. This one's picked up by Kayla Smith, searching for Angela D'Andrea. On the back line, Angela has it once again. She's got Capione near side, sends a slap shot just wide. Picked up by Howard. 6 minutes, 40 seconds left in the second period, 3-0 UMass Boston. Howard cycles around, finds space, saved by Salmon, rebound in front, knocked towards net by Smith, but it's saved again. The score stays 3-0 only because Maggie Salmon's been on her A game in the last couple of minutes.
Yeah, she's playing extremely well. I mean, I know her team's tired. First game ever. definitely keeping them in it. She's going to fight through to the end. You can just tell by the way she's diving all over the place, making saves by any means necessary. Credit to Maggie.
Four goaltenders on the roster, and Salmon stood out so far for Jamie Totten's Heron squad, and the effort is certainly there. Wind and fire from D'Andrio snuck through somehow, and a good job in front to screen the goaltender once again by Sam Fallon. That effort earlier led to the goal by Kayla Kiernan at the end of the first period. D'Andrio once again sends one on a bouncing puck deflected toward the net by Kiernan, but Salmon gets a piece of it and sends it wide. This one will roll all the way out towards center ice in the neutral zone. It's fought for by Plumeri and Morissette. Plumeri comes away with it. No teammates in front of her, so she'll just chip it in towards D'Andrio. D'Andrio with some time to settle it, but Plumeri gets in there once again to make things difficult. Behind the net, this is Kat Armstrong. She finds Fallon. Samantha says, you get that puck right back, and goes all the way near side.
And the D have done a great job tonight activating. They're up there in shots on goal, and I think that was the game plan going in. They've done a good job executing.
Here's Fallon, looking for her first goal of the season, perhaps. A shot or a pass towards the middle, either way, Salmon was there. Morissette was bearing down on net. And Fallon having a conversation, it looks like, with a referee and a player. But she'll get off the ice here with 5 minutes and 25 seconds to go in the second period. It's 3-0 UMass Boston.
And Tyler, I'd like to see that. You know, Fallon, her team's up 3-0. William Smith, no goals. But you know what? They're still competing. They're still going hard.
This is McIsaac off the faceoff win. Nicely done there by Alinardo. Behind the net, he finds Carlis, the captain. She gets dispossessed, though. McIsaac, a one-touch pass. He'll find Alinardo again. Near side circle, Carlis couldn't get a clean shot off, but gets a turnover in front. Shot towards Salmon, goes a bit wide. Still a chance to keep the pressure on. 5 minutes to go in the second period. This one comes to Alinardo. Wrapped around, is tracked down by Avison, a member of the defending Division III national champions, SUNY Plattsburgh of the ECAC West. And to make things even tougher on William Smith, they're joining that dominant conference who has the last two national champions, Elmira and SUNY Plattsburgh.
Yeah, that conference is definitely strong, and I think it's a good test here for the Beacons. They came in preseason ranked number 6, I believe, and I think definitely a good test for William Smith.
They're certainly up there. UMass Boston has earned themselves some high praise around this conference as a nice deke attempt inside by Federo is denied by the Beacons. It comes near side, Sarah Alinardo into the neutral zone and over the blue line. Now this is Sullivan. She scored already in this period. Sneaks a pass up ahead, hoping to find Avison, but she overskated it. And remember, first time these two players have been on the ice together ever. Former champion Avison is, and just got a bit too much speed on her attacking attempt. A good D on the back end by UMass Boston as the Herons continue to pressure despite the one-sided score.
And Tyler, Beacons want to be careful here. 3 minutes to go. You're up 3-0. Let's not give them any life. Let's go into the period at the end of two, up three, and looking to close it out in the third.
He's Matt Meisenbacher, former UMass Boston men's hockey goalie and a budding star in the hockey analysis industry. I'm Tyler Murray. I'm none of those things. 3.5 minutes to go in the second period. 3-0 Beacons. Good physical play. Embry gets in there, takes down a Heron, and the arm is up. Should be a penalty on UMass Boston.
Yeah, that's going to be two there. I mean, they're going for the puck, but anytime the stick gets in the skates and the player goes down, chances are it's going to be 2 minutes.
3:18 to go in the second period. That means we'll see the entirety of this power play before the period comes to an end, and it's our first look at the Beacons' penalty kill unit. Right now they've got Howard out there with D'Andrio, Carlis, and the quick shot off the faceoff sent right towards the goaltender, and Bradley handles it. And additionally out there, we've got Alexa Capione on the PK.
Yeah, and Tyler, this is a good test for the Beacons. Let's see how the PK responds here at the end of the second.
Looking forward to see what William Smith has to offer as well with the man advantage for the first time. Backhanded shot from distance, nearly snuck through, but Bradley at the last second knocks it away. Yeah,
that's a great reaction save there by Bradley. That's a tough bouncing puck, and she did a great job stopping it.
I don't know how she saw it in the first place, as UMass Boston is able to clear all the way down the river. Still 25 seconds left in the first power play of the season for William Smith. Beacon certainly not willing to sit back in a shell. They want to attack, maybe try for a shorty, as this one's knocked ahead by Capione. Chasing after it with a one-man forecheck, Emily Howard. Not as easy as it looks, playing with one man more than your opponent, especially with this good forecheck pressure. Handled there by McIsaac just onto the ice. She's joined out there by Kat Armstrong, Alyssa Sullivan, and Sam Fallon, who just came off the bench. Fallon is there. Picks it up, takes it over the blue line, goes down, but looked like a clean play from behind. William Smith has played a little bit more disciplined since they've had three penalties called against them in the first half of the game. None ever since the power play goal we saw late in the first.
Yeah, and Tyler, I think William Smith definitely trying to go in here, figure it out as they go, but Beaconson's done a great job on the forecheck. I mean, they're not really giving him much. There's not a lot of room to work with. They get the puck, throw it back in, and send another guy for the forecheck.
Sometimes it takes very quick decisions to get the puck out of your own end, and once you do that, sky's the limit for a transition chance and maybe an opportunity here, but Weingast couldn't play it cleanly. 20 seconds left on the man advantage. Fallon gets it out of the neutral zone. Picked up on the far side boards by Begley. Her pass all the way to this side. It is knocked away by McIsaac, and she'll just dump that one in. As the power play clock winds down, only 5 seconds left, and the Beacons are going to go one for one on the PK to start their season.
And Tyler, I think William Smith here, a little bit fatigued, probably looking for the period to end, go in and readjust.
A minute and 10 seconds to go in the second period. UMass Boston led 2-0 after one on goals from Emily Howard and Kayla Kiernan. Kiernan's goal came from the near side point with just 3 seconds left in the first. And in the second, Alyssa Sullivan dazzled the crowd with a heck of a deke and a backhand shot to beat Maggie Salmon, who has looked quite good so far in her NCAA debut.
Yeah, Maggie's been great. I mean, she's going to add some of these to her highlight reel. I mean, some of the saves she's coming up with, she's sprawling all over, legs flailing, I mean, making a lot of good saves. And the same can be said for Sullivan. If I was her, I'd throw that right on the highlight. That's got to go to YouTube and see how many hits it gets.
Well, we have a SportsCenter Top 10 highlight coming from Crystal Layden of the women's soccer team in just about 2 minutes during the intermission report. Maybe Alyssa Sullivan can join the crew for our next broadcast, which will be tomorrow at 1 o'clock for the men's hockey opener. They'll be playing UMass Dartmouth, and then the women's team will play again against William Smith at 4 o'clock. A doubleheader on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Dandrio from distance, her shot won't count, as it looked like Avison took down a Heron near side. Krista Federo hit the ice. It'll be interference. And off goes Avison for 2 minutes.
Yeah, Tyler, she knows better than that. That's an unnecessary penalty at the end of the period. And I know they're trying to make plays and keep momentum going, but with 27 seconds left on the clock, I don't think that's a good penalty right there.
So as Matt told you, under half a minute to go in this middle period. Faceoff won by the Heron. Shot from distance, knocked right down. 20 seconds to go, as you can see in the top right of your screen. With 15 left, it comes near side. A slap shot gets past everybody. A good job there, I thought, by Capion not to get a piece of it. Could have deflected towards the net, and Moe Bradley was ready for it. Back behind it goes for Dandrio. 4 seconds left. The clock will wind down on period number two. UMass Boston adds another. They led 2-0 after one, and after 40 minutes of hockey on the Beacons Broadcast Network, it is 3-0 UMass Boston. Mizey, what'd you think?
Another solid period by the Beacons. I mean, the power play looks good. They, again, kept a lot of possession in the offensive zone. But I think the one thing they want to be cautious of here is they got a minute 33 on this power play left. And if William Smith comes out and buries one early, it's back to a two-goal lead. We don't want to give him any type of spark. And I think William Smith is definitely going to come out and look for one.
And we talked about how good the Beacons looked offensively, especially on the power play in the first period. But if I'm Jamie Totten, the head coach of William Smith, I saw a lot of positives in that second period. If you just look at it on paper, he gave up two goals in the first, but just one in the second. And the only goal he gave up was just a great individual effort by Alyssa Sullivan. Not much anybody could have done.
Not expecting Maggie to come up with them, and she played great that period. And if I'm going in, I'm saying, hey, listen, our goaltender's in it. She's keeping it close, and I think if there's any type of light at the end of the tunnel, you've had some chances on Mo. And I think she's come up with some great saves, but I think you want to keep it going, try to get something early, and then you go from there.
So after 40 minutes of play, 3-0 UMass Boston. Now, we alluded to this a moment ago. The men's hockey team gets started tomorrow right here on the Beacons Broadcast Network at 1 o'clock, and we'll get you our season preview for 2014-2015. Should be a fun year.
Preseason, we had a pretty good train camp with the captains out here. We had a bunch of drills, flow drills, really just focus on getting the guys in shape after losing a week with the new rule change. So far it's been great the first week. I think it's up-tempo. Puck is moving along. We're moving it great.
Babson's been a rivalry ever since my freshman year. It's been preached on since they lost in the ECAC's championship in 08-09 to Babson. So it's all about it's beating Babson. I mean, you go into coach's office, it's beat Babson, beat Babson, beat Babson. We're looking for, we just need to beat Babson. It's essentially like once we get past them, we'll be fine. But over the past 2 years, we've definitely grown from a younger to an older team. It's been a transition from more of a grinding team to a skill team, which we have a ton of team skill and a lot of team speed. So that should help us from last year.
Simple mistakes. There's a couple of things that we went over with coach that he addressed these issues on Monday, which has been the focus, especially this week. There's little things that can determine these close games, and that's what we experienced the past 2 years.
But I think bringing in all the NESCAC schools with the Codfish and going to Wesleyan for Thanksgiving is going to really boost our really help show us where we stand with a lot of the higher ranking NESCAC teams. So I think we're going to be pretty well off.
I think we got it's a lot more of a competition this year. I think I've played with most of the guys through the first year and a couple weeks here and been paired up with them. Definitely towards the underclassmen end, there's got a few freshman defensemen coming in and transfers. Definitely look to see some of the sophomores step up. Guys like Mike Maciag, Boyd, Bishop to return to his role. And then transfers and freshmen to just step in. A guy like Mason and Axel just to try and step in and fill the voids we lost.
Billy and Zach both have been battling really hard. I know that they've had a couple of long days during the preseason with a lot of shots because it's just been those two. It's going to be a battle to see who's going to start on the first night. So, as long as they keep battling, we should be fine because both of them are going to play off of each other.
I think we definitely got a skill group up front. Incoming, I think you can look for Larkin to have a good year. I think he's looking at good minutes, putting up some points probably. He's a skill guy. And on the grinder end, I think we got good bottom six forwards as well. I think Albie's shown a lot this preseason in terms of throwing the body around and stuff, and other guys competing for roles.
We have the team. We have everything from top to bottom. Goaltending out first. If we just go day by day, game at a time, I think would be great.
I expect to do well. Definitely improvements upon last year. I think coming in, it was kind of an unknown. I didn't know what to expect. It was my first year here. I'm definitely looking forward to improving upon, beating some of the higher end teams. I think we've established ourselves as one of the good teams in the league. And I think now it's time to step up and kind of improve upon that.
Goals and expectations for this year is ECAC East. After that, we'll focus on more of a national championship, but I don't want to jump full forward to that.
Our expectation is an ECAC championship. Once we get through that, we can look on to the play-ins for the NCAAs and then to a national championship. But as soon as we get past, if we win the ECAC East, we'll be set.
Looking forward to an equally exciting men's hockey season, and again, that kicks off tomorrow right here on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Right now, you're tuned into the second intermission report of the women's hockey opener on the campus of UMass Boston. As you can see there, it's 3-0 Beacons in control. They score twice in the first. Emily Howard from Kayla Smith at 9:58, and then Kayla Kiernan from Kat Armstrong at 19:57. Just 3 seconds left in the first period. And then in the second, about halfway through, 8:29, Alyssa Sullivan with an even strength goal. She dangled around a couple defenders and somehow beat the goaltender Maggie Salmon with a backhand wrister to make it a 3-0 Beacons lead, but it certainly has not been all UMass Boston. We definitely want to tip our caps to what William Smith has accomplished so far. Two shots in both periods, and they're not cheapies. Moe Bradley has certainly been challenged in net, at least when WSC can get themselves a shot on net. We've seen some good things from most of their players. Remember, all freshmen for William Smith, so tough to stand out, but Krista Federo has done well, Grace Durham very active, and Lizzie Weingast had a couple of big hits. One of them got called for a penalty, but physicality always welcome on the ice. We've got the full second period stats for you, as you can check them out yourself. UMass Boston was able to continue to dominate shots. That's not a repeat of the first period stats. It was exactly the same, 16-2 in the first and second periods. The Beacons, as you can see, looking pretty good on the power play so far, with William Smith having their chances. And don't forget, they'll have a minute 33 left on their power play as we start the third period. Faceoffs, as you can see, have been dominated by UMass Boston, and you'll certainly be impressed, I think, by the efforts of the freshman Jane Morissette. 10 for 14 to lead the Beacons, and you can tell that's something Colleen Harris, the head coach, noticed right away for UMass Boston. Morissette knows that a win in the circle, a freshman, the lone freshman dressing this evening, being able to dominate her competition in the circle. As for William Smith, their leader in faceoffs, Krista Federo, she's 3 out of 4, not too shabby. 7 minutes to go until we get ready for period number 3. As you can see, the Beacons have that 3-0 lead as the Beacons hope to continue their dominance in the opener. We'll take a commercial break and come on back, look around Beaconville, and we'll also have that highly anticipated highlight of Crystal Layden on the SportsCenter Top 10 earlier this week. Stick around. It's the Beacons Broadcast Network.
Go Beacons! Let's go Beacons! Let's go Beacons!
Come on, Jake!
As usual, she wins it. A chance in front. Her shot is in the net. Crystal Layden, yet another goal.
Please make a gift to the Beacon Athletic Fund today. We want you on our team.
Division 3 allows you to give yourself to other things.
Having that free time allows me to pursue the things that I want to pursue.
Division 3 athletics affords students the opportunity to, you know, engage in the other interests in their campus and in their lives outside of that sport.
It allows you to just be able to do everything you want to do. I wouldn't change it for the world.
My name is Allie Greenberg. I'm an ice hockey player here. I'm a junior majoring in human services, and I'm part of the Key for Hope Foundation. We recycle the keys and stock food pantries with the money. I wanted to bring this foundation to the athletic department, and I believe we can end hunger starting at UMass Boston. I got started with the Key for Hope Foundation due to my father. He's the one who founded this program.
I said, what can I do with a classroom environment giving back? And everybody's got an old key, and keys are made of brass, and brass is a recyclable commodity. And thinking about how many children are in a school system and how far we can go with taking this to do something right for humanity, I started a foundation called Key for Hope, feeding others with the collecting of keys. In 2.5 years, we collected over 500,000 keys. And I'm excited about this whole opportunity because you know what? One key may not seem like much to most people, but when you collect the masses of keys that we've collected, it shows that there is an ability for people to get together and create what I'm considering our hunger-fighting opportunity.
The University of Massachusetts Boston, with its scenic oceanfront campus, easily accessible to downtown Boston, is recognized as a model of excellence for urban public universities. 16 NCAA Division III sports are part of the more than 100 student organizations that create an engaging campus life in America's biggest and best college town. UMass Boston, Boston's urban public research university for the 21st century.
I did receive a non-athletic scholarship upon entering school.
I got the presidential scholarship, which was huge for me.
I think there's more opportunities for academic scholarships in Division III.
I did receive academic scholarships. Just being involved on campus, being a leader, all those things combined kind of get me recognized. It's a great experience for me.
Three and a half minutes to go before we hit the third and final period. As promised, let's take a quick look at the women's soccer team's highlights against Bridgewater State and keep an eye out for the highlight reel goal from Crystal Layden.
Senior forward out of Bridgewater, Massachusetts, number 12, Crystal Layden.
Talk to folks who were at that game, say the number could have even been double. She was so successful getting open all game long, and she hit four posts as well. Here she comes again, looping behind the defender. Layden pokes it on, and it's into the back of the net. 100 career goals for Crystal Layden. Delayed it. Here's Crystal Layden again. First shot off a block and just wide of goal. Throw in. That ball had rolled to the other side of the flag a couple seconds ago. It would have been a goal kick instead for Bridgewater State. Higgins get it up top. A shot on goal and it's into the back of the net. Marina Kelly scores. Ball skips right off the foot of a Beacon defender. Here's a drive from distance. Big save, Perkins. Layden. Here comes Crystal Layden again. Blazing past the defense. Layden puts it over the bar. Continue to play it back on the defensive end, and here's some pressure coming once more from Bridgewater State. This one's crossed into the center. Here's a shot, and it's into the back of the net. Bridgewater State's right back within one. Still 18 minutes to go. Turn and burn for Layden. Here is Krista Layden heading in, centering pass, chipped on goal, and into the back of the net. The Beacons are back up by two. Layden to Kelly. Does it. 3-1 win for the Beacons here on LittleEast.tv. We'll be back in a flash to wrap it up on LittleEast.tv.
Back live on the campus of UMass Boston. 20 minutes separate the Beacons from an opening night win over the scrappy William Smith Herons. And as we welcome back Matt Meisenbacher into the broadcast, you had mentioned during the break there were a couple of players, maybe just one, that you want to keep an eye on in this third period for UMass Boston. Of course, they look pretty good score-wise, but at this point you want to see some good individual efforts to see who's going to stand out this season.
Absolutely, and I think in a senior-dominated roster, it's nice to see a freshman, number 7, Jane Morissette. She's really stepped up. She looks great tonight, and I'd like to see that continue in the third. It's always good to see a freshman who's not timid coming into the first game.
We talked about it right after the second period ended. She has 10 face-off wins and 14 tries, leading all skaters. Don't forget, it's a penalty kill for the Beacons. 1 minute and 23 seconds left in the first power play. Well, the second power play, in fact, beg your pardon, for William Smith. Going right to left now, as you can see. The Herons in the green and white, the Beacons in the blue, white, and black. Cycling across the middle, it's Federeau, comes near side for Hetty Drosty. Drosty gets the puck right back from Kylie Fuster all the way DDD to the other end for Grace Durham, but her pass up ahead is taken away. Nice job there by Kristen Embry to send it all the way down the river with under a minute to go in the power play.
And Tyler, really, really key here. Mo's coming out of the locker room. She's been sitting down for a while. There's no way she's loose. She's going to need her team here to bail her out and get off this power play.
There really has been a good battle so far between Bradley and Salmon. As you can see, though, on the scoreboard, the Beacons have the advantage. Nice pass all the way around to the far side point to find some space for Durham. Durham looking ahead for Fuster, who gets it back to Durham, and she'll send this one into the netting to the far side corner. Whistle blows. 25 seconds left in the power play. A line change for the Beacons.
And Tyler, this is a key situation here. Let's not take our foot off the gas. Beacons want to keep going here. And if I'm William Smith, I'm saying, hey, listen, power play to start. Let's get off on a good note, one at a time.
Jenny Curry can't win the faceoff. It's won by Slicklin. Near side it goes. Emily Burton, still 20 seconds left on the power play for the Herons, but this time Burton can't keep it in. All the way down it goes. Chasing after it with speed is Jenny Curry. A good race, but she can't win it. Nicely done with speed by Rebecca Begley to shield off the former Colgate standout. Into the zone again it goes. Andy Plumeri gets dispossessed by Angela D'Andrio as the power play clock winds out. 18 minutes, 20 seconds to go into regulation. The Beacons in control here with a 3-0 lead. Icing waved off here. Good hustle there by Carlos on the far side and Avison on the near side. Four skaters fighting for it. Goes far end now for Capione all the way back around. This one rolls towards the corner, and it's picked up by Alinardo. Gets turned around, looking for her teammate down deeper. That's Lizzie Avison, but Avison has this one taken away. Capione, a good interception at the point, and a chance here. Here's the captain with a wrist shot glove there by the goaltender, Salmon. Alexandra Carlos with the best chance all night, but she couldn't elude Salmon.
Yeah, that was a great save there, and I think Carlos looking in, she's trying to go under the bar there, and Salmon said no, right in the glove.
17:50 left in this one. Want to take this time to say thank you to Carl Poss and Jose Pena, our directors here today. Carl Poss, the boss, and Jose Alde Pena. They're going to be with us all weekend, making sure the broadcast stays tremendous, and any mistakes you see, it's their fault. 17 minutes and 30 seconds to go in this one as Kiernan comes across the blue line looking for a teammate. Try to slip one back behind for Jane Morissette, but no luck. Picked up by Lizzie Weingast. Lumbers across the center ice line, but has it taken away, and it winds up with Catherine Linehan. Linehan is dispossessed there by Jane Morissette. Her backhand pass goes in towards the corner. Far side point, knocked around by Armstrong. Armstrong has that one intercepted. Near side center ice. This is Alyssa Sullivan. Gets it right back on a quick return pass from Armstrong. Sullivan dangles across the blue line, stops on a dime, saucers one to the near side, but it's knocked down at the blue line by Morgan Bayreuther. Bayreuther's pass intercepted by Armstrong. At the near side half boards, Capione has it taken away, but a good job on the back check by Michaela Fea to keep possession with the Beacons for the time being. She'll pick that one up off the boards very quickly. Gets tangled up with two different Herons, though. A good diving pass attempt by Kylie Fuster is intercepted by Alyssa Sullivan. 3-on-2 if the Beacons can hurry. Sullivan cuts toward the middle. Wrist shot saved by Salmon. Conley in net with a couple of Beacons bearing down on her. She avoids the rebound and keeps this a 3-0 Beacon lead.
Yeah, another glove save there by Salmon. Definitely working for her. But Sullivan coming down the wall. She's got everything working tonight. Hands, feet, shot, everything.
Face-off win there for Curry. To the far side point for Armstrong at the circle. This is Jenny Curry, sends a deflected shot towards the net, and Salmon somehow reacts in time to put the glove on it.
Yeah, probably a high stick, might have been called off, but you know what? Salmon's going to stop it anyway for good measure.
So 16 minutes and a quarter to go, 3-0 in the third period. Another face-off win off the win. It's Capione to send one on net, knocked down, but a rebound allowed that time by Salmon. Still, though, her teammates help her out to clear the danger. Carried out by Bayreuther. Knocked in towards the neutral zone. Picked up by Kayla Smith. Goes near side for Emily Howard. Has two defenders on her. Frees up. It looked to be a Smith opportunity, but it gets past her. At the near side glass, Krista Federo was almost able to find some space for Bayreuther, but it gets all the way past her. Down for icing with 15:43 to go in regulation. Line change coming for UMass Boston. Looks like Sullivan is out there with a couple of her line mates. Carlos. With McIsaac at the back of D'Andrio joining her. Avison's in there as well. She gets the puck right behind the net. Has Carlos in the middle, but her pass goes all the way through. D'Andrio from distance, and a stomach save made by Salmon.
Yeah, you can see there, good technique from Sam, and that's a shot from the point. D'Andrea was able to step into it and not only hit her in the breadbasket, but Salmon, really good job bringing that glove over, allowing no rebound. She's been doing it all night.
So Carlos Alinardo and Avison out there. Face off one to D'Andrea. Sends a bouncing puck in towards the slot, but it goes wide into the corner. Avison now, centering pass deflected high in the air. Knocked down with the glove by Alinardo, but couldn't get the stick on it. Still a good job to keep the puck inside the blue line, but it didn't last long. Taken away there by Slicken. Johanna Slicken with plenty of speed. Cuts inside, but it's knocked away by D'Andrea. Great stick work there. 15 minutes left in regulation. There's no room in the slot right now for the Herons, and D'Andrea's play a big part of why. Avison sends one on net, but Salmon was ready for it and got some good help from her defender to cut off the angle.
And this is where the Beacon's leadership needs to take over. You're up 3 in the third period, 5 minutes in. You're telling everyone, hey, listen, the game is not over. A lot of time on the clock. We need to maintain, stick with the game plan, and finish like we started.
Morissette wins another faceoff. Capione from distance. This shot deflected away. Could be a chance for the Herons if they can control possession. They do for a bit, but this one's knocked away. Offsides warning is on, and because the puck was played there by Linehan, it's going to be brought back into the neutral zone. 14:45 to go. 3-0 Beacons. Howard, Kiernan, and Sullivan with the goals. Face off right down below us. One again by Morrison. Backhand pass ahead by McGinley. Casey McGinley finds Kayla Kiernan. Centering pass from Morrison is out of her reach and handled behind the net by Emily Burton. Her clearance is knocked down by Sam Fallon, who keeps it going for the Beacons. There's Fallon. Backhand shot trickles wide. Maybe didn't realize how much space she had, but the effort she put forth to get that space, quite admirable.
Yeah, you get in that position, your hands start jumping a little bit. You know somebody's coming.
There's Samantha Fallon again, trying to freeze the puck up to allow Kiernan to come in and scoop it away, but she can't quite get there. It's picked up there by McGinley. Now Kiernan cycles to the top of the point. Distant slap shot on a one-timer by McGinley directly towards the goaltender, and Salmon's positioning has been good all night.
Now, we haven't said her name much since the pregame, but Bradley's been down there by herself, and I know as a goaltender it can be very difficult mentally staying in a game when you don't have a lot of activity, so it'll be interesting to see eventually when the play does come down her end how she responds.
On the stat sheet, just 4 shots put on net in the first 2 periods, and a lot of them were very tough to stop, and Bradley was able to do so. A big hit at the Beacon's blue line, or the Heron's blue line, rather. No call made, though. Incidental contact. Good, clean hockey out here on the Beacon's broadcast network. This is Kristen Embry. So slide one all the way down. Racing after it is Sullivan and Faya. But somehow a good job made by Burton to get her stick in there first. She controls behind her own net. Slides one all the way around for Bayreuther. Good keep in that time by McIsaac. Knocked right back out to her, though, at the neutral zone. She'll whip this one into the zone. And a line change for the Beacons. In comes Curry, along with Howard, who makes an interception there. She's got Curry to her left. She'll send this one on, and it goes wide.
It might have got a bit of the post there, Tyler, a bit of the outside.
I thought so, too. Either the goaltender or the post saves William Smith from a 4-0 deficit. Comes near side for a Howard. That's Kayla Smith, who races after it. Out there with Curry and Howard behind the net. Smith out to the far point. D'Andrea with plenty of space finds McGinley near side. Her shot goes high and wide. A dangerously high stick that time by Howard, but no harm, no foul. Loose stick in that corner, as you can see. 4 skaters fighting for it, and it's wrapped around the board to the near side, where it can be picked up by Curry. She'll try to leave one for McGinley. Couple of kicks in there, and she can't get her skates down. And she'll have to play it back in the neutral zone. This is D'Andrea. Good stick handling here. Over the blue line all by herself. It comes near side. This is Curry. Kenny Curry gets it back near side. McGinley with space for a shot, but it goes well wide. And it's tracked down by Smith, who loses the race to Linehan. Towards the scorer's table on the far side. It's picked up by the Herons, but a pass looking for Slicken, intercepted by McGinley. Slicken, though, a chance to possess once again. However, D'Andrea gets there first. 11 minutes and 42 seconds to go in regulation. Nearly a costly turnover. Distant shot goes high over the crossbar. Not terrible accuracy there from Sarah Garrett under pressure, but not too tempting, it would seem, for Moe Bradley. D'Andrio again with it. She finds McGinley, who looks to find Curry, and Jenny's pass probably in the worst spot possible, but fortunately.
Yeah, you never want to see that, Tyler. You got a one man forechecking, one woman, I should say, forechecking, and not a good play there. You don't never want to give it to the slot with a guy hovering.
And Plumeri was right there hoping for a chance, but it just deflected off her skate. Fortunately, or stick rather, fortunately for the Beacons. Now this is Howard. All she saw was green jersey, so she just smacks one all the way down. Sullivan races after it. Out there as well as Avison. Morissette joins the fray as well. Capione is in the action, but a hand pass is called against the Herons, so it'll be a neutral zone faceoff.
And Tyler, if this was football, this would be a case where we're going to run the ball, run out the clock, but I think what the Beacons are going to try to do here is not deviate too far from the game plan. You want to make sure you're not taking unnecessary risk, yet 10 to go up three, play smart hockey.
I said neutral zone faceoff. I meant offensive zone, of course, as Armstrong lets fly, goes too high, fouling on the rebound attempt, couldn't settle it, and it's taken away by Plumeri, who has it ripped away by Morissette, who's been maybe the best freshman on the ice so far this evening. The only Beacon freshman who is dressing, but you can tell she's ready to go for what could be a long and fruitful UMass Boston hockey career.
She's been strong, and I also want a number 16, Lizzie Avison. She's wheeling around. She looks quick. I like what I'm seeing from her as well.
That is, she's in her first year as a UMass Boston Beacon, transferring from the championship SUNY Plattsburgh hockey team last year. The ECAC West. Halfway through the final period, UMass Boston scored two in the first, one in the second. Goals for Howard, Kiernan, and Sullivan. Assists for Smith and Armstrong. Four shots in two periods for William Smith. Moe Bradley's been ready for all of them as Fallon tries to slip one through. But once again, Maggie Salmon is there. She saved 29 of 32 shots in the first two periods. I think however this game winds up, Maggie Salmon's got to feel pretty good about what she's been able to do.
I would say so. She's been strong all night. And I think, to be honest, she hasn't seen it all. The whole game has been down her end, and she's maintained the entire time.
Diagonal pass for D'Andrio, gets past one defender into the slot, but her centering pass is deflected wide. Off the near side glass, it goes to McIsaac. She gets turned around, and it looks like maybe a breakout opportunity for the Herons, but Federo couldn't get away cleanly. Now Embry leaves one back behind her. D'Andrio once again dangling into a dangerous area, but circles back around, dumps it in. And this is Sullivan. Embry. Good look in towards the center, but couldn't get all the way into Michaela Fea, who chases down this one behind the net. Joined by Sullivan, but it's taken away by Durham. Not a bad job that time by Bayreuther to get it between the legs of D'Andrio, but couldn't find a teammate. Now this is Michaela Fea, a high slot chance. Perhaps she'll wait for a teammate. Sends it into the corner, and a line change coming. This will be Michaela Smith line with Jenny Curry and Emily Howard. Down hard goes Sullivan. Got hit on her way to the ice. No whistle blown. She's still down, and we'll see how long they take to blow this play dead. It'll certainly be after this opportunity from Krista Federo. Federo spins, centering pass, deflected in off the skate of Morgan Bayreuther. How do you like that? 3-1 the score. Bradley was there, but off the skate between her legs, it's a two-goal game.
Yeah, an unfortunate play there. Sullivan went down behind the play, something with her shoulder it might be, and sure enough, down the other end, off the skate, and I don't know. Bradley, pucks have a way of finding their way home, and she wasn't able to get it. It's an unfortunate goal there for Bradley, but Beacon's still up 3-1 here with 8 to go. They need to be careful.
A big roar from the William Smith faithful here. A lot of families making the trip from the Geneva, New York area. Two-goal game. We'll see what we have in the final 8 minutes. The Beacons certainly can't sit back now and try to defend this lead. There's Bayreuther's goal being announced. A Assist from Federo, as we said. Centering pass near side, knocked around, and somehow saved by Maggie Salmon. Used her rear end to make that play, it looked like.
Yeah, that's a great save. That's one off the toe there. She really extends to make that save. No rebound, and a good shift by the Beacons. Good way to respond after a unfortunate goal midway through the third.
We'll have the Carlos line out there now. She's joined by Avison and Alinardo. Face-off won by Carlos. She finds Capione, who gives to McIsaac. Defensive pairings have been switched up a bit, with Salisbury getting a rest. She got a bit banged up in the second period and was able to walk off under her own power, and she showed up later on the bench in the game, but no reason to force things, it would seem, as this one goes all the way down. Capione is there. He's able to find Carlos, who gets it all the way up ahead to Alinardo, who just sends this one down the ice. Avison gives chase, can't keep it in the zone. Indirect pass by Linehan, hoping to find Weingast, incomplete. It goes near side for Linehan. Her centering pass finds nobody with a green jersey. Instead, it's taken away by Kat Armstrong. All the way down towards center ice it goes. Puck gets tangled up there in the gear of Kayla Kiernan, but she knocks it down towards her skates and gets the puck away from the neutral zone. And at this point, not the worst thing in the world. Just keep the puck in the offensive end. This is Dandrio Rister, deflected in front, turning around Linehan. Linehan still gets there first, though. They avoid the referee. Linehan gets around Dandrio, who went down to her knees, and it's taken by Kiernan. But still, there's Linehan. Just wants a line change, though. She'll dump it in, and the Beacons can pick it up.
And I got to give William Smith credit here. Down two, it's been a kind of a rough game. A lot of time in their own D zone, but they're showing some life here, trying to get another one.
You can imagine how exhilarated they must be to be able to get on the board with so few shots, but still, getting past Moe Bradley is no easy task for anybody. One-time chance in front, but Bayreuther couldn't get her second in the last 5 minutes. 6.5 to go. In regulation, 3-1 is the score. Now Samantha Fallon creates her own space, eludes three different skaters on the Herons. She gets inside the offensive zone but can't finish the play. But for better or for worse, she runs the clock down for the Beacons as she'll hit this one on the backhand behind the net.
A great individual play. Fallon, leader, coming through, making sure that the Beacons are still sticking to the game plan.
It goes from Smith to Capione. Alexa over the blue line. At the circle, top of the point now. This is KC McGinley. Backhand attempt in front, rebound. And an effort by Curry there to put it on net, denied. One-time shot, though, deflected away yet again as Embry was bearing down in the slot. And somehow she couldn't put it on target. A lot of pressure inside as UMass Boston keeps possession. Capione with some space. She'll go across to McGinley. Rister from distance, kicked away by Salmon into the corner. Loose puck, far side board, still in the Beacons' offensive end. Plenty of space now. This is Kayla Smith from distance. Low shot, knocked away, rebound into the far post and knocked away yet again by Salmon.
Kayla Smith's another one, number 11. 5'7 sophomore, and here's William Smith with a chance.
Blue Mary gets one off from distance, but a good job in pursuit by Capione to knock it away.
Yeah, I was saying Smith has been another one. She's buzzing around the net. I believe she has a few shots on goal. She looks strong.
Playing on that very effective top line with Curry and Howard. Smith assisted on the Howard goal that gave the Beacons a 1-0 lead in the first 10 minutes of tonight's action. It'll go near side. Now this is Blue Mary. Tried to slip one across the blue line, but it's intercepted by McGinley, who's been pretty effective on that back line during these last couple of shifts. Filling in for Jess Salisbury. All the way down the ice it goes. This ought to be icing. And we will indeed bring it back to the Beacons' offensive end. 4 minutes, 23 seconds left. 3-1 UMass Boston leads. That goal from William Smith certainly gave them a jolt, but the Beacons have been pretty solid in response.
Absolutely, and the clock is absolutely on their side. 4:23 left to go. Really not much to do here except a catastrophic type of play can really, all of a sudden that clock's your enemy and you're waiting for it to count down. They just need to stick to the script.
Nearing 4 minutes left in the third period. The Beacons certainly hope it's the third and final period. They've been in control thus far. 2-0 lead after one, a 3-0 lead after two, but now it's just a two-goal game as Curry controls. Showing off her skating ability, gets it near side where she finds Carlos. McIsaac from distance has a shot knocked down by Slicklin. Keeps it alive on the blue line, though. This time it's Carlos. Gets one around. This is Curry centering pass, knocked around. Is Salmon know where it is? I'm not sure. And a mosh pit in front of the net results in a dead puck. Whistle blows. Couple of skaters go down, but no goal is the ruling. 3-1, the score remains.
Yeah, it was a nice little play there by the Beacons. Carlos off the wall, dropped it down low. She goes to the net. They try to stuff it in and doesn't go in, but a nice play here late in the third period.
3 minutes, 47 seconds left to go. Conversation in front of the net between the referees. Morissette wins another one, but she sent it towards her winger, Avison, who couldn't connect with her blue liner. So all the way back it goes. Armstrong finds Capione, who somehow, while losing an edge, got the puck away. Avison to the far side for Morissette. She'll send one a bit too far for the streaking Alinardo. Crowded blue line here, and wisely Capione just slaps that one out of danger. With 3 minutes left to go in regulation. Far side wraparound. It's knocked up by Morissette. Somehow finds the puck in a dangerous spot. Gets double teamed. Taken down. No call made. Near side it goes as Avison wanted the call, but instead she'll fight for the puck. Looking to lift a stick in the near side corner. Morissette has the space for it. Gets hit from behind, or at least grabbed from behind. Wraparound chance. It winds up being a pass all the way to the other end of the boards. And Capione dumps around once again. Off the ice comes Morissette. She'll be replaced by Kayla Smith, who sprints into the fray. Has some space on the far circle near the dot, but the Beacons can't get her a clean pass. There's Smith with the puck.
And this is where the Beacons want to be. They're in the offensive zone here, running out the clock, and I think William Smith, you're starting to see a little bit of fatigue.
Smith once again, a shot deflected in front. That was Hedy Drosty to knock it away. Drosty couldn't possess here. Around the net, this is Smith once again. She'll find Armstrong at the point. She'll go D to D for Capione. 2 minutes to go, knocked away with the right leg by Drossi. That one might have been earmarked for the goal. Centering pass in front, Sam Fallon just off the bench gets derailed in the slot and couldn't get the shot off. Good play, though, to set her up for an open chance.
Beacons with an opportunity here. Caught William Smith on a late change.
Nice one-touch pass by Sam Fallon. She frees up Kiernan, who scored at the end of the first period. Her pass towards the middle knocked away into the corner. Behind the net, a good job by Durham to elude Capione. Over the blue line, now this is Bayreuther, who scored the first goal in William Smith NCAA history about 10 minutes ago. Fallon couldn't get the stick down. Slap shot from distance wound up being a one-timer from Burton. Is deflected wide. Centering pass winds up behind the net. Still loose, and McGinley gets a piece of it. A minute 20 left. Beacons have done quite well to possess the puck and just control the clock. D'Andrio has it. Up ahead to Kiernan. She'll knock this one indirect off the boards, and beautifully done as the nets is empty, as you can see, for William Smith, 6-on-5. 60 seconds left. Embry's in there. McIsaac gets a stick on it. Offsides warning here, so they can't get across. Carlos will bring it back out to the neutral zone. McIsaac up ahead to Embry, back to the net. So turn and fire, that's a goal. 4-1, the Beacons have all but put this one away. An empty netter for Kristen Embry and a three-goal cushion with 41 seconds left.
Well, nothing left now for the Beacons but to talk about what they're doing for their Halloween costumes. 41 seconds left, and, you know, a good play there. Embry, just turn around and fire. I guess as long as it's not an icing, you might as well take a shot, eh, Tyler?
Well, I won this Ron Burgundy last year to go off your Halloween point, but you can't repeat. That's just not.
Does that mean I'm brick?
Absolutely not. You are the guy who says whammy. You know who you are. 35 seconds to go. Whistle blows at the Beacon blue line. It'll be a faceoff. This one's all but over, as Matt Meisenbacher just told you. Don't forget, we'll be back with a 1 o'clock start for a Saturday matinee. The Beacons men's hockey team taking on UMass Dartmouth, and the women's team right after that.
And Tyler, I think we got to give it to William Smith. Pretty good effort here. First game in not only of the season, but all time for William Smith, and they really put a valiant effort forward. It's not easy, and they did a good job, I think.
A good save on a tough angle, far side post by Salmon, who might wind up being the third star of the game. Who knows? She played quite well between the pipes, and I think you're right, Mizey. You really can't overlook what William Smith is able to do. A lot of positives for them to take away. And I'm very happy, to be honest, to see them score that goal, to give them the confidence to know that they have what it takes to be able to put points on the board and continue to improve as the season goes on.
For sure. I mean, they're realistic. I mean, you see them here. They're taking a timeout, 20 seconds left. I think they're just trying to build whatever type of momentum they can for tomorrow, but really a good effort. And for most of this game, it was relatively close.
Don't forget to stick around after the conclusion of the third and final period. We'll have a post-game recap for you. We'll break things down. We'll show you the final stats, and hopefully we can get to talk with one of the coaches or maybe a player on the Beacon squad this evening. Certainly a lot of standouts to choose from, and we'll have our three stars of the game. You don't want to miss that on the Beacon's Broadcast Network post-game show. But you're right, a timeout, hoping to maybe just learn about how to get these opportunities set up and what it's going to take to be able to break through against a tough team like the Beacons, who right now just want to do anything but let a goal in.
Yep.
And that's how it was when it was 3-0 as well. And we saw the Herons break through.
Absolutely. And I think, like I said, they're building momentum for tomorrow. They know they're going to be playing the same team, probably mostly the same lineup, and they want to build on something.
A lot for Coach Jamie Totten to think about, and she certainly should be proud of her squad this evening. Goalie staying in the net for now, trying to creep out of there, and there goes Salmon. A 3-on-3 here as this shot's knocked away. Bayreuther has been a standout, and again, a chance for a goal-scoring opportunity there as the clock winds down on the season opener on the campus of UMass Boston. 4-1 your final. The Beacons get 2 in the first, 1 in the second, and a good job by the Herons to get their first NCAA tally in the third, but UMass Boston, Matt, a little bit too much tonight.
Yeah, I think, you know, senior leadership, you've got a roster full of seniors and upperclassmen, and Moe Bradley in net is definitely someone to be noted beforehand, and the Beacons did a good job. They executed their game plan, as the scoreboard lets you know, 4-1, and a good momentum builder for tomorrow.
We'll take a commercial break, but don't go anywhere. A post-game interview, our three stars of the game, final stats, and much more. Final score, 4-1. Beacons win, but a great effort all around, especially from William Smith in their first ever NCAA contest. Stay tuned. Plenty more coming up on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
My name is Allie Greenberg. I'm an ice hockey player here. I'm a junior majoring in human services, and I'm part of the Key for Hope Foundation. We recycle the keys and stock food pantries with the money. I wanted to bring this foundation to the athletic department, and I believe we can end hunger starting at UMass Boston. I got started with the Key for Hope Foundation due to my father. He's the one who founded this program.
I said, what can I do with a classroom environment giving back? And everybody's got an old key, and keys are made of brass, and brass is a recyclable commodity. And thinking about how many children are in a school system and how far we can go with taking this to do something right for humanity, I started a foundation called Key for Hope, feeding others with the collecting of keys. In 2.5 years, we collected over 500,000 keys. And I'm excited about this whole opportunity because you know what? One key may not seem like much to most people, but when you collect the masses of keys that we've collected, it shows that there is an ability for people to get together and create what I'm considering our hunger fighting opportunity.
As usual, she wins it. A chance in front. Her shot is in the net. Crystal elated. Yet another goal.
Please make a gift to the Beacon Athletic Fund today. We want you on our team.
The University of Massachusetts Boston. It's just minutes from downtown, and the Princeton Review calls it one of the best values in the country. A nationally recognized institution of academic excellence and research, UMass Boston offers more than 150 undergraduate and graduate programs, 16 Division III sports, and more than 100 student organizations. To learn more about the opportunities waiting for you at UMass Boston, visit in person or online.
UMass Boston, a research university with a teaching soul.
The University of Massachusetts Boston, with its scenic oceanfront campus, easily accessible to downtown Boston, is recognized as a model of excellence for urban public universities. 16 NCAA Division III sports are part of the more than 100 student organizations that create an engaging campus life in America's biggest and best college town. UMass Boston, Boston's urban public research university for the 21st century.
Something I discovered in myself is that if I have a goal, I can accomplish it.
It's a well-rounded experience.
At a Division III school, you're primarily a student athlete, so the school is really shaped around you developing yourself as a complete individual.
It helps a lot that you have a family with your team that can guide you.
Paris changed my life, and I got there through UMass. Those very specific seminal moments in Paris, the subway. A man in a tuxedo walked in, and a woman in a long gown, and it was stunning. It all hit me. It was like a lightning bolt. There was this world of beauty and style that I wanted to be a part of. That was the beginning of the journey, and that all came through the University of Massachusetts. And that was really a key moment for me. That's one of those moments you never forget.
Division III allows you to give yourself to other things.
Having that free time allows me to pursue the things that I want to pursue.
Division III athletics affords students the opportunity to, you know, engage in the other interests in their campus and in their lives outside of that sport.
It allows you to just be able to do everything you want to do. I wouldn't change it for the world.
I did receive a non-athletic scholarship upon entering school.
I got the presidential scholarship, which was huge for me.
I think there's more opportunities for academic scholarships in Division III.
I did receive academic scholarships. Just being involved on campus, being a leader, all those things combined kind of get me recognized. It's a great experience for me.
Glad you stuck around, folks. We're basking in the glow of opening night hockey. Just came to a conclusion. Beacons 4 and the William Smith Herons 1. We'll have the full game stats for you in just a bit. Our three stars are coming up shortly. And then we'll have an interview with head coach Colleen Harris. And I think, Matt, if you're Colleen Harris right now, you have to be pretty happy with the way your team played. They battled the whole way through. Really didn't take the foot off the gas pedal, even though they were in control the majority of the evening.
I would say so. It's always nice to start the season with a win. And I think if I'm Colleen, there's definitely some things that I saw that need improvement. But overall, 4-1 win, you're going home happy and getting ready for tomorrow.
Let's take a look at those final stats. A great job by Carl Paus and Jose Panda to put these together for us. As you can see, the Beacons put up a ton of shots this evening and only 5 saves needed by Moe Bradley, but they took advantage of the power play. We saw some great faceoff work, especially from Jane Morissette. And we said it a lot earlier in the game. It doesn't give William Smith, it doesn't do them justice, I don't think. They played very well. They kept it close, relatively speaking, but obviously this was the Beacons' night to start their season.
Yeah, the stats aren't always totally representative of how the game went. I mean, it was a fairly close game for most of it, and although the score was 4-1, I think you got to give credit to Salmon. I mean, she really stood on her head and came up with a lot of good saves. Her rebounds were strong all night, and, you know, William Smith, they buried one. I mean, something to build on for tomorrow.
Let's check out our three stars of the game, hand-selected by the man himself, Matt Meisenbacher. We've got Kayla Kiernan with a game-winning goal, first star, and then you can't overlook what Maggie Samuel was able to do, and Alyssa Sullivan, who had that nasty goal in the second period. She gets the third star. Break that down for us, Matt. I know you had a pretty good impression of what Maggie was able to do today.
Yeah, fantastic. I mean, Alyssa Sullivan, highlight reel. Like I said before, took one out of Patty Kane's book, dangled around 2 or 3 people, backhand underneath the bar. Maggie Salmon 43 saves. A great way to start the season for her. I know she gets a loss, but overall, I think she's got to be happy with that performance. And Kayla Kiernan, solid game overall. She got the game-winning goal, and she's on the score sheet.
I wanted to ask you this during the game, Matt, but while we have a couple of minutes before we had a talk with head coach Colleen Harris, Maggie Salmon was able to really stand out today. Four total goalies on this roster, and you've certainly had your fair share of success in between the pipes during your collegiate career. What do you think allows a goalie like Maggie Salmon to stand out and separate herself, at least for the opener, over so many talented players on the roster in terms of goaltenders for the Herons?
Yeah, she's definitely well aware. There's four goalies on the roster. She knew getting the go tonight that she was going to have to play well in order to maintain that starting role. And I think what you saw is a goalie that really wanted to make saves. She was across her crease very quickly. She made a lot of fine saves on her back. I saw a good kick save at the end. She looked real strong, and I think going into it, she got in a groove early. I mean, her shots on goal each period were in the teens. She got in a groove early. She was able to ride it out, and although she gave up four, I think overall, with the amount of shots she faced and the amount of time in the zone she faced, pretty good performance. I'd say you're probably likely to see her next game unless coach has something preconceived already.
Keep in mind, it's going to be under 24 hours before the Herons and the Beacons face off again tomorrow around 4 o'clock, pending how long the men's game goes. They're playing at 1 o'clock against UMass Dartmouth. Looking forward to a doubleheader tomorrow right here on the Beacons Broadcast Network. The goals were scored for the Beacons by Emily Howard, Kayla Kiernan, Alyssa Sullivan, and Kristen Embry. Embry's goal came with an empty net. Kayla Smith, Kat Armstrong, and Kelsey McIsaac get the assists for UMass Boston. And the goals for William Smith come from Morgan Bayreuther, and the assist, Krista Federer.
And Tyler, a few things to make note of. We've had some injuries on the Beacon side. I know Salisbury went down fairly early in the game. We're going to have to make note of that. And also Sullivan. When William Smith scored their goal, she was down behind the play. I saw her afterwards. She was moving around on her own, but definitely something to take note of for the game tomorrow.
We'll take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we will have Colleen Harris, the head coach of the Beacons, for an interview to break things down and wrap things up on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
Go Beacons! Let's go Beacons! Let's go Beacons!
Come on, Jake!
As usual, she wins it. A chance in front. Her shot is in the net. Crystal elated. Yet another goal.
Please make a gift to the Beacon Athletic Fund today. We want you on our team.
Division 3 allows you to give yourself to other things.
Having that free time allows me to pursue the things that I want to pursue.
Division 3 athletics affords students the opportunity to, you know, engage in the other interests in their campus and in their lives outside of that sport.
It allows you to just be able to do everything you want to do. I wouldn't change it for the world.
My name is Allie Greenberg. I'm an ice hockey player here. I'm a junior majoring in human services, and I'm part of the Key for Hope Foundation. We recycle the keys and stock food pantries with the money. I wanted to bring this foundation to the athletic department, and I believe we can end hunger starting at UMass Boston. I got started with the Key for Hope Foundation due to my father. He's the one who founded this program.
I said, what can I do with a classroom environment giving back? And everybody's got an old key, and keys are made of brass, and brass is a recyclable commodity. And thinking about how many children are in a school system and how far we can go with taking this to do something right for humanity, I started a foundation called Key for Hope, feeding others with the collecting of keys. In 2.5 years, we collected over 500,000 keys. And I'm excited about this whole opportunity because you know what? One key may not seem like much to most people, but when you collect the masses of keys that we've collected, it shows that there is an ability for people to get together and create what I'm considering our hunger fighting opportunity.
So we're here with Coach Harris after the game. And Coach, I know, quick turnaround, we got the same team tomorrow, but what were some of the takeaways from the Beacons' point of view?
I think we had a pretty solid game. I think we were fast paced for the most part up until probably 10 minutes left in the third, but a lot of shots on net, pretty good scoring opportunities, but we got to learn to put the puck not into the goalie's chest.
Sure. And for William Smith, I mean, that's their first game ever.
Mm-hmm.
I know from up here, it looked like they played fairly well, given the circumstances. What were your thoughts?
I thought they were really good, actually, for a first game ever. All first years they had on their team, and they were extremely disciplined. You could tell that they've practiced their systems. Their goaltender played great, so they definitely didn't give it to us easy.
Sure. And as we said, same team tomorrow, so without giving too much away, going into tomorrow, thoughts?
I think it's going to be a similar game. I think they're going to come back with a little bit more confidence, so we're really going to have to shake things up a little bit and wheel and deal out there, be able to bury the puck a little bit more. Changes in the lineup, maybe. Can't be sure. There's a couple kids who small injuries tonight, so better safe than sorry. But hoping we can put 4 or 5 up on the board tomorrow night.
Sure. Well, thanks, Coach. Good luck tomorrow, and we'll take a quick commercial break on the Beacons Network.
Thank you.
Division III allows you to give yourself to other things.
Having that free time allows me to pursue the things that I want to pursue.
Division III athletics affords students the opportunity to, you know, engage in the other interests in their campus and in their lives outside of that sport.
It allows you to just be able to do everything you want to do. I wouldn't change it for the world.
My name is Allie Grunberg. I'm an ice hockey player here. I'm a junior majoring in human services, and I'm part of the Key for Hope Foundation. We recycle the keys and stock food pantries with the money. I wanted to bring this foundation to the athletic department, and I believe we can end hunger starting at UMass Boston. I got started with the Key for Hope Foundation due to my father. He's the one who founded this program.
I said, what can I do with a classroom environment giving back? And everybody's got an old key, and keys are made of brass, and brass is a recyclable commodity. And thinking about how many children are in a school system and how far we can go with taking this to do something right for humanity, I started a foundation called Key for Hope, feeding others with the collecting of keys. In 2.5 years, we collected over 500,000 keys. And I'm excited about this whole opportunity because, you know what? One key may not seem like much to most people, but when you collect the masses of keys that we've collected, it shows that there is an ability for people to get together and create what I'm considering our hunger fighting opportunity.
Final score from UMass Boston. Beacons win 4-1 over the debutante William Smith College Herons. Speaking of debutantes, a great job this evening from Matt Meisenberger during the game and as you guys just saw after the game. So what'd you think of the game? What'd you think of your debut on the air? Did you have fun?
I did. I enjoyed it. I mean, as you guys know, I've always been a talker. They call me the mayor of Beaconville. I have nothing to say about that. But you heard it from Coach. I mean, in terms of the game, pretty good battle on both sides. And I think with the quick turnaround, it's going to really be a matter of who takes care of themselves tonight, who rehydrates and who stretches out, because it's guaranteed to be a battle again tomorrow.
Final reminder, a 1:00 men's hockey game with Matt and myself, Tyler Murray. So tune in for that, and then immediately afterwards, we'll fire up the women's hockey rematch between the Beacons and the William Smith College Herons. 4-1 your final tonight, and we can't wait for more hockey tomorrow. Thanks so much for tuning in, and we'll see you later on the Beacons Broadcast Network.